The high in the upper 70s. We'll see a return to some sunshine from Huntsville West. Clouds and some isolated showers may hang on east of Huntsville across northeast Alabama. A little hotter for the rest of the week, but not as hot as last week. Highs in the mid-80s. Take my forecast and WBHP with you everywhere. Download the iHeartRadio app at WBHP1025.com.
At Mattress Firm, for a limited time, take home a free adjustable base with purchase of $6.99. Plus, get up to $400 in savings and enjoy 0% APR for 6 years. Zero down and zero due at signing. Shop the Save Big Sale online or in store.
ADP isn't just in the payroll business. We're in the people business, helping companies find them, train them, and empower them by clearing the way for them to do their best work. Because when your people thrive, your business thrives with them. HR, talent, time, benefits, and payroll. Informed by data and designed for people, so you and your company can achieve what you're working for. Learn more at design.adp.com.
Say good morning to Mike Holt, Holt Siding and Replacement Windows. Mike, tell us what you do.
We install vinyl siding, energy-efficient replacement windows, gutters, shutters, just anything that will go do with exterior upgrades to your home.
And, Mike, it's important that people know they can depend on you.
You know, when we do a job for a customer and we put a sign in the yard, you know, that's my name on that sign. I'm as proud as I was in the first 24-foot walkboard I put on a truck and thought, boy, I'm downtown now because I've got a walkboard. You know, I started this from scratch, from nothing. So when we put a sign in your yard and we tell you we're going to do something, we take a lot of pride in that. And we take a lot of pride in checking up with our customers on down the road, call them up, and just a phone call. How's the windows doing? How's things going?
And experience matters.
Now, I've got guys that work for me that have a lot of experience. I tell our customers, we don't come to your house to gain experience. We bring it with us.
Call for your free estimate today. Holtz Siding and Replacement Windows, 256-288-0050.
Say good morning to Roger House, APS, Alabama Professional Services. Roger, let's talk about pest control. What do you see most lately?
This time of the year, we see a lot of ants. Also mosquitoes right now, they're out. Ticks and fleas. Your American roach.
Do you also do like yellow jackets and
we do yellow
wasps.
Jackets, wasps, hornets. We cover all insects. I've been doing this 26 years, and if you have a problem, we're going to take care of it.
Call APS Foundation Services today, 256-417-4293. Or go to AlabamaProfessionalServices.com and ask Roger.
Real news.
So Bernie Sanders actually had a heart attack.
He had a heart attack. That'll nix his campaign.
He was discharged Friday from the hospital. He's down in the polls, but that's not because of the heart attack. That's because he's so angry all the time. So he says he feels great. He's going to be on the debate stage.
Honest opinion.
We're liable to see a medical, and instead of it being Hillary falling and coughing and stuff, Bernie's liable to have a medical emergency live on the TV.
And a dash of humor just for fun. Awarded best talk show in the state of Alabama by the Alabama Broadcasters Association. This is the WBHP Morning Show. Now, here's your host, Tony Lowry, with Corey Moss.
Welcome into the morning show. It is 5:04 on Tuesday. We've made it through a rainy Monday. You have any idea how much rain we got yesterday? I mean, it rained for a long time yesterday morning. Then it kind of filtered off yesterday afternoon with sprinkles. But
I can find that out, though.
You know, it was more than a quarter of an inch. It rained a lot for a long time.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it did.
So I don't know if they have that bucket out at the airport, you know.
And that's whenever we give you those official numbers.
That's where it is.
It's wherever their official station is, usually at the airport.
At the airport, yeah. But we needed it. We needed the rain.
Oh, absolutely.
And it's a lot cooler out there. Step outside and feel that.
Feels good.
Yep.
60? Yeah, 60 degrees. Well, that's from an hour ago. Let's update that, see if they've updated that. 61.
Oh, it's gotten warmer?
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
Well, so it
odd.
Says.
Oh, yeah. It was 60, and now it's 61.
Mm-hmm.
That is very odd. Winds at about 8 out of the north, but it does feel good out there. And we're going to have mostly sunny today, right? 76. Well, you're looking up the...
Yeah, I was trying. Yeah. Mostly sunny today. 76. Beautiful fall day. We like it. Mm-hmm. Even a north-northeast wind, 5 to 10.
How about that?
Mostly clear down to 57 tonight.
Ooh.
sunny tomorrow, 82. And the wind switches from the north-northeast to the south-southeast.
Of course it does.
5 to 10 miles an hour. Down to 62 tomorrow night. Cloudy, partly cloudy skies. Mostly sunny. On Thursday, 85.
Yeah, so what's up with all that?
What? 85 is not bad.
Well, I know, but here we are, 70s, and now we're going back up again.
I know. Well, we've got to get another reinforcing cool front in here. Mostly clear, 63 Thursday night. Back up to 85 under sunny skies Friday. Then here comes another cool front. 30% chance of showers and thunderstorms Friday night. Low 55. Then a 30% chance earlier in the day on Saturday. Otherwise, mostly sunny. Only 68 Saturday. Down to...
It's all over the place.
43.
See, that's what I was talking about. Saturday. We haven't even had any fall, really. And now we're going to get to 43 Saturday night.
That'll be chilly.
It will be cold.
Sunny 74 Sunday. Down to 47 Sunday night. And then Columbus Day, Indigenous Peoples Day, sunny 76.
So 74 on Sunday and 76 on Monday and 76 today. But that down to 43 Saturday night?
It's crazy.
Yeah. Again, we're gonna walk right into winter. That's what's going to happen.
Now, on the hurricane map.
That is weird.
All of a sudden, we've got three X's from yesterday's one X. And there is a... I don't get why they're putting outlooks or forecasts out because of nothing but low pressure systems over Florida.
That's what it is, too.
Yeah.
It's a disturbance is what they're calling it.
Oh, yeah, it is. Yeah, it's disturbing. Some light development of this system is possible today.
10% chance of formation within the next 5 days, so why is it even there?
Yeah.
Disorganized showers and thunderstorms.
Then we got another one, pretty much in line with that one, that at the moment is on top of Florida. This one is off the coast of the Carolinas. I think this is one we talked about yesterday.
Yes. Still sitting there, right?
Showers and thunderstorms over the western Atlantic between the south of what?
Yeah,
okay.
It's the same
showers
one.
And thunderstorms. And they're giving it a 30% chance of becoming a cyclone. And then the one that may actually do something, although they're still calling it a non-tropical low-pressure system, it's out in between Bermuda and the Azores.
Mm-hmm.
But they've got it headed
this way,
this direction. So we'll have to watch it and see what happens. 50%
chance, like you say. Yeah. And we'll see. Those other ones are basically going to stay offshore, though, the other two.
Yeah, I think so.
And you're right. They're in a line. They're training, huh?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Come on, ride that train.
Well, they're staying away from Cancun. That's all I care about.
Are they there yet?
Thursday.
Okay.
Alicia told me yesterday they're flying into Mexico City and then across. And it's like, what?
So they're going down to Mexico City first?
Yeah, I guess that's where they change your plane. Of course, Cancun's in Mexico, so.
How about that?
I guess,
can't get one way, I guess?
Well,
it'll probably cost you an arm and a leg.
Yeah. So from Nevada, which is where they're flying, you know, that's a little different than where Cody's flying from Atlanta.
Is he going direct?
I'm sure they'll fly out of Atlanta direct.
Okay.
Yeah, because there's nowhere to stop in between the U.S. and Cancun. You can't even know where to lay over.
At the moment, I haven't found what Huntsville got. Okay, so according to Jason Simpson, what we needed in rain yesterday to get rid of the drought was 10 inches.
10 inches?
10 inches. Henniger, that's the first city up on the list he put up here. Henniger got this almost 7/10 of an inch. Madison got 2 inches.
Yeah, we got
a little over 2 inches.
I was going to say, we got a lot of rain.
And Moulton got nearly 3.25 inches of rain. I'll see if I can find some more numbers for you. But, yeah, we got a lot of rain yesterday. The problem, you know, he said we needed 10 inches, and we did.
Not at one time.
And we do, I guess. But, yeah, over,
time.
You know, 3, 4, or 5 days, you know. And it, because when the ground is so dry, it takes a little bit to start absorbing that.
Yes.
That's why we had so much trouble yesterday. I mean, it was raining hard and fast, but it couldn't.
It wasn't soaking up.
It couldn't soak quick enough.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So we need slow rain.
Yes.
Over a few days.
17 hours ago. Okay. This is from 17 hours ago, so take that as a grain of salt. But out at Huntsville International Airport at that point, they'd got an inch and a half. And Decatur had gotten 2 inches. So
so basically...
Suffice it to say, we got a lot of rain yesterday.
Yeah, so it looks like across the valley we got from a little bit to what Moulton would be the most, I guess, 3 inches.
I guess that's why he put that on there, yeah. Moulton was the most.
Mm-hmm. But it did rain, rained a lot, and yep. A lot of people had a lot of trouble yesterday, and then we had the power outages on top of that.
Mm-hmm.
You shouldn't experience any of that except for maybe power outages. Who knows? The 72 up there has been experiencing power outages for a few days,
mm-hmm.
back and forth, for different reasons, it looks like.
Yep.
So something's up there, near Balch Road, County Line Road, and near the flea market.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so they've been experiencing some problems. So just be careful, traffic lights and things like that as you move along. But it's cool out there and it's dry. You know, the interstate was dry. So, you know, we're pretty good this morning.
I just saw this on Facebook. Anyone with a chainsaw want to help me out? I've got a tree on my car and my saw's messed up.
So
I hate that for you. That's a weird Facebook.
We didn't have enough wind to, did we?
Overnight? Or you mean yesterday?
Yeah.
Yeah, trees fell.
Okay.
Yeah, there were several reports of trees falling.
So it must have been a pretty big gust somewhere.
I don't know why they fell. I mean, there wasn't much wind.
I didn't think.
And the ground's not soggy.
No.
It's dry as a rock.
Maybe in anticipation of a big wind.
Maybe they were weeping willows.
And they were waiting, said, yeah, let's go ahead and fall.
Yeah. Timber.
Thank goodness it's his car and not his house or anybody hurt.
No kidding.
Anyway, so we've got that. We're going to talk some Syria this morning. There was a lot of backlash yesterday on the president.
Well, he gets what he got coming to him on that.
Yeah.
Although.
Well, I was going to say, there's some other circumstances happening here.
Is it true that it's only like 25 troops they're moving?
50.
50 is what you've seen?
Yeah. That's what the president said, 50. And I think they're advisors, and they're only in one area.
Mm-hmm.
It's not everywhere. They're advising the Kurds. So
it's really not that. That's exactly right. That's what I read, too. It's really not the fact that we're pulling out. It's the fact that we're pulling out and allowing Turkey to go in.
And I still have a lot of research. I did a lot of research yesterday after I helped try to change the alternator on that black car. But I held the tools.
I was about to say.
And the bolts.
It shouldn't have been too hard. It was on top, wasn't it? Wasn't it right there on top?
Yeah, it was on top. The only problem is the other day when Chance drove it, he pulled it in forward because it was about the battery wouldn't start. You know that new battery you put in there?
So it was obviously the alternator because that's a brand new battery.
Yes. Anyway, so he pulled it forward, and I said, no, you got to figure out how to back it in, or nobody can work on it.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to figure out how to keep it going long enough to...
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, anyway.
Did you get it backed in?
Yeah, I backed it in. I started it. They
I wish I'd been
jumped
there for
it
all
off.
That.
Had to move Chance's truck to do it, though. You know, that white truck.
Mm-hmm.
Got it started, and then in a real big hurry, I had to... back it up, go forward, back it in, try not to run over other cars. And
she can't drive as it is, folks.
I was taking hand directions.
Right.
And then it died. So, anyway.
Did y'all get the alternator on?
No, we got the alternator off.
Oh, okay.
Now, you got to take the old alternator and turn it in to get
Don't buy a new one. Don't buy a new one. It's a waste of money. Get your refurbished one.
Well, these are refurbished.
Okay. It's a lot cheaper than the new ones. And the car...
I don't see how. But
anyway. Trust me, it is.
Okay.
In the age of that car, you just need a refurbished one. There's no use in spending all that money on a new
one. But you take the old one and get... Anyway.
Yes.
Forget all that.
It's called a core charge.
That's what they said. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. So forget all that. On the Kurds.
We talk about.
I know. You get off on something.
I can't help it.
So, have you ever heard of the PKK? Do you remember hearing about them?
I've heard of the PKK, but it was not people. It's a gun.
Okay, PKK are people. Okay. They're Kurds.
Okay.
Okay, there. It's the Kurdish Workers Party.
Okay.
And
they're the ones that's been working with us.
No.
No.
This is an armed terrorist group.
Oh.
Of Kurds.
Really?
And actually listed in the United States and the European Union as a terrorist group.
Wow.
And they're a Marxist-Leninist separatist group.
Wow.
Yeah, okay. So there are...
Screwed up.
Like everybody else, there are different factions of people.
Sure.
Now, there are the good Kurds who are wearing American flags on their jackets as they're fighting for us.
Mm-hmm.
And then there are bad Kurds, this party, the KKK, or PKK.
Mm-hmm.
And so their whole point is to... annex part of Turkey. Okay, so do you remember in the first Gulf War? No. The first Gulf War.
Oh, I wasn't checking my head at you.
Oh, okay. First Gulf War, the Kurds, the good Kurds, helped us with Saddam Hussein.
Yeah.
They helped us in the first Gulf War.
Yes.
And then we abandoned them.
Yes.
George H.W. Bush said, well, that's not our deal. And he left. And then Saddam Hussein
killed him.
Killed him.
A bunch of them.
With chemical weapons.
Mm-hmm. When they find
bodies.
Millions of people in mass graves.
Well, that was different. Those weren't Kurds.
Oh, those weren't the Kurds?
No, those were Iraqis.
Okay.
Who didn't abide by Saddam Hussein's.
I got my graves mixed up. I'm sorry.
It's okay. So there's been a lot of confusion over the various Kurdish political and military groups in Turkey
mm-hmm.
for a while. And so the PKK is who is fighting Turkey. Mm-hmm. Turkey is fighting them. Now, Iraq, if you look at Iraq, the northern part of Iraq is where the Kurds are. Remember when they wanted to have their own country?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
You know, they wanted to get out of Iraq and have their own country. Well, what would happen is...
So Turkey's fighting the bad Kurds,
well,
not the good
well,
Kurds?
Well, how do you tell the difference? See, this is the problem.
Mm.
You got bad Kurds, you got good Kurds. You got the PKK, who they've been fighting for... When you hear Trump talking about how the Turkey has been fighting the Kurds for decades, for millennia,
mm-hmm.
it's the PKK
yeah.
that he's talking about. But he's not making himself clear, of course.
He never does.
Good Kurds who... helped us get rid of ISIS, and if it wasn't for them, I'm not sure we would have gotten rid of ISIS. We wouldn't have gotten rid of the caliphate if it hadn't been for the Kurds fighting with us. So here in Turkey in itself is a, I mean, he's a bad guy. I mean, I know he's
Erdogan.
A quote-unquote ally, but, you know, he's arresting journalists, and they had that big coup,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, they... Trump got the pastor out of prison,
yep.
you know, but they wanted the pastor here that's got refuge here that the Turkey says is their main cause of protesters. No, it's because you're a bad guy.
Yeah.
You treat your people horribly and you're turning into an Islamic state.
Yep.
I mean, it's bad in Turkey. But with the PKK, their terrorism, I mean, tens of thousands of military and civilian deaths over the past decades from the PKK.
Hmm.
I have to do a little more digging on where, you know, so what the PKK was doing is they were going from Iraq, and they would go across the border, and they'd attack Turkey, and then they'd run back.
Mm-hmm.
Now there's a bunch of them in Syria.
Right.
But... There are the good Kurds in Syria that we promise we would protect like we did in the first Gulf War, and we can't abandon them. Now, Trump says there's only 50 advisors in this one area. If it's just that one area...
I heard it was fewer than that.
That Turkey wants to...
Problem is that's a slippery slope.
Go in and eliminate the PKK?
Yeah.
Okay, right. So what's going to happen is then, if if we don't, which we still have our troops in Iraq right there where we can send them over if we need to.
Well, yeah, I mean,
it's not like we're leaving the whole area.
Trump's right by saying, you know, we can pull out, monitor things, and go,
back. Because we have all those troops right there.
Of a finger.
Because all those troops are right there in Iraq.
Yeah. Well, we have what they call planes, Tony. Oh. We can get there in a few minutes.
Well, that's true. And we have ships out there.
Absolutely.
But the problem is that when you remove the good Kurds, or where are the good Kurds? All right, here you go. Where are the good Kurds going to go?
That's a good question.
Where are they going? And how are we going to protect them? How are you going to differentiate between the bad Kurds and the good Kurds? It's kind of like John McCain when he went over there and said all those freedom fighters were for us, and yet we found out that a bunch of them were not. They were bad guys. Yeah. Remember that when he took that picture?
Yes, yeah, with
the
terrorists.
The guy he took pictures with were terrorists.
Yeah.
It's hard to differentiate. Now, you have another problem here. If it looks like we're leaving, because if we leave, the U.K. is going to leave and France is going to leave too. They're only there because we're there, some of their advisors and stuff.
Well, that's kind of what Trump's wanting is them to step up.
Yeah, well, they're not
going to
step
up. But they're going to turn around and leave,
They're going to leave too. So what you're going to have is in that one—
We're like everybody's big brother.
Well, yeah. And as he said yesterday, the police force.
Yeah.
We can't be.
No.
But having said that, what you're going to have left is Turkey, Syria, Assad, Russia, and Iran.
Good Lord. What could go wrong?
All right there together.
Yeah.
Now, we thought that Turkey hated Iran, but yet he had a meeting with the Ayatollah
Khomeini.
Yeah. So did Russia. So did Syria. So if they're going to create a force in that part of Syria— Now, the point was to defeat ISIS. So we did that. That doesn't mean they're not coming back. They're going to come back, always going to come back.
Always, yeah.
It may not be in that one particular area because they all hate ISIS because they have their own thugs.
Right.
Right?
Hmm.
So, and then what about Israel?
I haven't heard anything from them.
Not a word. Is that going to put the Iranians even closer? Because, you know, the Iranians have already been sending through Hezbollah and Hamas have been targeting Israel with their missiles. I think what a lot of people, especially military people, General Keane and others are saying is if we remove ourselves, it just gives Iran and Russia, Syria, and Turkey more opportunity.
Well, it seems to me we've learned that lesson.
To build up.
Or should have.
Well, we learned that when...
In Afghanistan and Iraq.
Well, yeah, because when Obama pulled out of Iraq, that's what created ISIS.
That's right.
If you leave a vacuum, then the bad guys are going to fill that vacuum. But what we're doing is just fighting. The Kurds are fighting. But who are they fighting? Are they still fighting ISIS in Syria? Are they fighting Russia? Now, having said that, you know, we dropped a bunch of missiles on a bunch of Russians and killed them.
Yes, we did.
Mm-hmm. And
I thought there was going to be an international incident.
That was great.
But it didn't.
But no. But you know what? They were thugs and they were killing the Kurds. So I don't know. You know, there are ISIS sleeper cells already ready, plotting. Okay, so here's the other thing. You know, Trump has been railing that we have 60,000 or something like that prisoner of war people, right?
Yes, and their families.
And we can't take care of them, and we can't send them all to Gitmo and take care of them.
He didn't want to send anybody to Gitmo.
No, billions of dollars. Well, it costs a lot of money.
I know it does.
Why should we be the, unless the...
Because we're the only ones that can keep them, or that will keep them locked up.
All right.
These other countries won't even take them back.
Well, no.
And they're their citizens.
Right, because they don't want to spend the money either.
I'd put them in a plane, a parachute on them, and say, good luck, is what I'd do, and drop them over their countries.
Well, he said he was going to drop them at the border of each country, but I don't see how he's going to do that. So if you're going to send them to Gitmo, if you were going to send them to Gitmo, what you'd have to have is money sent from, you'd have to figure out how many of these ISIS fighters were from which country, and then charge them for the upkeep.
Right. Yes.
That's what you would have to do. Nobody's talking about that, but that's what I would. That would be the first thing I'd say. Okay, you want us to keep them? All right, France, you've got 6,000 of French citizens, so your bill is going to be X amount a month.
Mm-hmm.
And UK and, you know, same thing, okay? Well, they're not going to do that. They're not going to pay for that. They just want us to keep them.
Right.
Okay, so they're, so if Turkey goes in and attacks this area, right?
Mm-hmm.
Which a lot of people say would...
Is it only like a 20-mile swath?
I've heard that too, but I'm not sure about that. Mm. Because there's already a plot to break free. There's 12,000 jihadis detained by Syrian Kurdish fighters, 12,000 mm-hmm. ISIS fighters.
Mm-hmm.
And so what they're saying is if Turkey goes in there and attacks that, it would then ISIS... other ISIS people are going to try to break free these 12,000 jihadis and have them join their ranks.
Mm-hmm.
So if you have all these, there's several camps, it looks like. The one you were talking about, there's a camp that's home to 70,000, mostly wives and children of ISIS fighters. Mm-hmm. And then you have this prison area that has 12,000 ISIS fighters, the fighters.
Yeah, when he was talking about that, I was thinking to myself, well, surely you aren't housing them all together.
No, they're separate.
I mean, and put the terrorists in prisoners.
Well, they are. They're in a different camp.
Yeah.
But what we were doing yesterday is we were evacuating certain areas, certain positions where Turkey was going to come in.
Mm-hmm.
We were evacuating Kurds from there. But where are we evacuating them to? Are we evacuating them back to Iraq? Are we taking them somewhere else? So I don't know.
But now the Kurds are the ones guarding these.
The good Kurds.
Yeah.
The good Kurds are guarding these ISIS fighters and the 70,000, mostly wives and children.
Well, who's going to watch them if we evacuate all of them?
Well, then Turkey's going to take them. That's the whole... That is, so if Turkey takes the ISIS fighters and the wives.
Well, they'll just let them go.
Exactly.
Liable to. I mean, I don't know whether they will or
okay,
not.
Okay, so, or are they.
Erdogan's crazy.
When Erdogan says, I'm attacking Kurds, and he attacks the good Kurds, then what happens? Well, Trump says that we're watching, and if you attack the good Kurds, that we're going to put.
Sanctions on you
to totally destroy your economy, which he has done before. On Turkey. He put sanctions on Turkey before. Again, the good Kurds, you know, have been the main U.S. backed force in Syria in the fight against ISIS. If it had not been for the good Kurds, we would never have been able to eliminate the caliphate without putting more boots on the ground.
Right.
They were our boots on the ground,
mm-hmm.
the good Kurds. The PKK, on the other hand, Marxist, leftist, radical, I mean...
Terrorists.
They're mm-hmm. terrorists. So, I don't know what the answer is. I mean, if we do this and let Turkey come in and kill off those bad Kurds that are in that 20-mile, they're too close to Turkey.
Yeah.
So he wants a buffer.
Who's he, Erdogan?
Erdogan wants a buffer there. That's where your 20-mile strip of land comes in.
Mm-hmm.
But everybody's in the same spots, it looks like. Everybody's in the same area there.
Hmm.
And again... Then then what do you do when Iran and Russia and, you know, eventually what they want to do is have some kind of a waterway or some kind of an opening, some kind of a way, because it's kind of landlocked in that area of Syria, but they want a way in order to have direct access via water to Europe.
Okay.
Okay, I have to look at a map again. I looked at that one time, but anyway. But right there in that part, they're landlocked. Okay, well, that would mean, that's two things. Number one, that would mean that Russian ships and stuff could come in, too, back and forth quicker. So you have the bad side, and then you have the good side of trade and this and that. So I don't know what the answer is. Hmm. Maybe he's just throwing this out there to see what would happen. If we only have 25 to 50 advisors in that area right now, what are we doing with the good Kurds?
Can't we advise from afar?
We can advise from afar, but what are we going to – I think the question right now that everybody's latching onto, including Democrats, they don't care about the good Kurds.
But, well, no.
But they're saying, oh, yeah, treason.
This is something else against Trump.
Is how – what do we do with the good Kurds and how do we save them? We can't abandon them. They fought with us. How many times have they fought with us? Wearing American flags on their jackets, yeah. You know. So the and they are accusing Washington of failing to abide by its commitments, too, the good Kurds. They're saying, wait a minute.
Yeah.
We're your allies. We fought against ISIS, and now you're just going to abandon us.
Well, I'm not for pulling out completely of those areas because we know what happens when that happens.
Right,
do
the vacuum.
That. But, number one, Trump campaigned on this, and he was elected.
Yeah.
He said that he was... I mean, he doesn't want to be a Rand Paul isolationist. By the way, Rand Paul, the only one
that's
on the president's side at the moment.
True.
And that's not where I'd want to be if I were the president. Although I do like Rand Paul, and I feel bad that he's been beaten up.
Yeah.
But literally. But
by his neighbor, yes.
Yeah. That's crazy old neighbor. I'm okay with trying it, but we can't allow... Once we see it's going south, we got to get right back and stop it.
I know he said that we can go right back in, but we don't want to have to go. We don't want it to. We don't want the same situation that happened when Obama pulled out of.
No.
Because then what happened was there were so many ISIS. How long did it take us? Years to get rid of them. But so we can't.
How long, though, did Obama wait?
Oh, years.
Yes. That's why I say it. As quick as we see it going south. Got to step in and then
what happens? You've got Iranians and Russians and Sarah and Turkish and
a mess.
Everybody there.
Can't we just put America under a dome and say, y'all have at it. Figure it out, your damn selves.
Well, no, because,
and leave us alone.
No, because if they blow up the Middle East, I mean, we're still part of the world. I mean, we got to have
dome. If we got our dome, heck with it.
Yeah, but we're eventually we'll run out of air in our dome.
Oh.
So I'm just saying. Having said all that, I want to hear from you guys. What do you guys think?
There is no easy answer.
And no, they got to be real. Like I said, we should not abandon the people who fought.
No.
For
absolutely
us.
Absolutely not.
Again. We shouldn't abandon them again.
Mm-hmm.
But what do you guys say? But then a lot of these people aren't telling the exact truth of what's happening either.
No.
So.
The media is going to blow it
no matter
as
what.
Far out of proportion as possible.
And Republicans.
I mean,
even Lindsey Graham and McConnell all said that this was a bad idea and said some pretty harsh things.
I know.
Lindsey
Graham called it a knee-jerk reaction by the president.
Yeah.
No.
Well, he tried to do it 9 months ago, and that's why, what's his name, is no longer
Mad
there.
Dog Mattis.
Yeah, Mattis isn't there anymore, yeah. Anyway, so what do you guys think? Call us. We want to hear from you. Phone numbers are
256-534-3521 and 309-2313.
We'll be right back.
Miss Tony and Gary? Listen to our podcast free anytime, day or night.
And check out our blog at tonyandgary.com with links to the podcast, email, iHeartRadio, listen online, and all the latest stories and video.
Listen to WBHP on your Amazon Echo. Just say, Alexa, play WBHP on iHeartRadio.
And like us on Facebook. Go to facebook.com/Tony and Gary.
It's the morning show with Tony and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
And now on 102.5 FM.
During a medical emergency, every minute matters. That's why at Crestwood Medical Center, you'll find less waiting where you need it most, in our emergency room. In fact, we will work to have you initially seen by a medical professional with the shortest wait time possible. And because we're a full-service hospital, we can provide more care if you need it. If you experience a medical emergency, count on the ER at Crestwood Medical Center for great care with less waiting.
Hello, I'm Keith Pinkerton at Mr. Electric. How do we make things better? Our customers say it better than we can.
Professional, top notch.
They were on time.
Fixed it on site.
I'd recommend Mr. Electric to anyone.
We're proudly making things better in the Huntsville area. And we're proud to be a neighborly company. We're Mr. Electric. We have the power to make things better. Visit MrElectric.com.
Now you can listen to The Michael Berry Show on your Amazon Echo device. Just say, Alexa, play WBHP on iHeartRadio.
It's hot and your air is out. You need it fixed now. Call Joe East 1 Hour. Celebrating 50 years of serving North Alabama, Joe East 1 Hour offers the best in heating and cooling sales and service. Weekends, holidays, no problem. Joe East 1 Hour is on call to take care of your cooling emergency. Our technicians are some of the best trained in the business. And if you need a new unit, call the experts at Joe East 1 Hour Heating and Air. Remember, at Joe East, we're not comfortable until you are. 256-851-6510. 851-6510. Always on time or you don't pay a dime.
Express your opinion. Let your voice be heard. Call the WBHP Morning Show now at 256-534-3521 or 309-2313.
Hello, Americans. I'm Todd Starnes with news and commentary next.
What do you see for the next generation? Do you see a prospering nation? Do you see hope? The future is ours to create. And Liberty University is driven to train positive influencers for our country and our culture. Our mission is to guide students toward leadership as servants of the people, defenders of freedom, and champions of truth. Discover how you can impact the next generation of champions for Christ at liberty.edu/starnes.
DeMario Davis is a starting linebacker for the New Orleans Saints. The other day, he was fined more than $7,000 for wearing a headband with a Christian message. The headband was emblazoned with the words, Man of God, a big no-no in the National Football League these days. Mr. Davis tells the Times-Picayune newspaper that he loves God, and he was hoping that by wearing the headband during the game, that God would get the glory. But the NFL has a rule that bans personal messages on uniforms. Ben Roethlisberger of the Pittsburgh Steelers was slapped with a $5,000 fine for wearing an Apple Watch. Now look, the NFL is free to make whatever rules they wish to make. That's not the issue. But I do find it interesting that a personal statement about the Christian faith is not permissible, but a personal statement about the national anthem is celebrated. Be sure to check out ToddStarnes.com for more news and commentary.
Debt is dumb. Dave Ramsey tells you why.
The credit card industry spends more money marketing the credit card than the entire car industry spends marketing cars. The entire housing industry spends marketing houses. Think about it. Is there anything else that is in your face to buy more often than this product called a credit card? Debt is a product that is sold to you. Listen today at 11. The Dave Ramsey Show on WBHP.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is sponsored by Bill Penny Toyota's service department.
Tuesday morning, first check on traffic. Off to a good start around the valley. We're not spotting any problems with the weather. So far, it's a good ride around Athens. No problems around Decatur on the Hudson Memorial Bridge. 565 moving okay around the Arsenal. No problems on the parkway. Heading over Chapman Mountain in good shape. No problems on 431 around Big Cove. From the traffic center, I'm Captain Carl.
Need convenient and reliable service? Bill Penny Toyota's got you covered late night, Monday through Thursday, 7 a.m. through 11 p.m. Plus, receive a Lyft credit and other discounts after 6 p.m. Ask for Bob. Visit BillPennyToyota.com. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
Train presents The Unstoppables. Those captains of comfort who let nothing overcome their profound profession. Those gargantuans of the guarantee. Those comfort kings with a tireless tenacity for total turnaround. The train comfort specialists. Just one more reason why it's hard to stop a train.
Call Bo Thomas, your train comfort specialist. 256-858-4822. Or go to coolhuntsville.com. Thomas HVAC. It's hard to stop a train.
WBHP
is available everywhere you want to listen on our free iHeartRadio app. Download it now.
Welcome back to the morning show. Okay, what are we giving away?
$40 for Popeye's Cajun Fried Chicken. Movie passes for two at Hollywood 18.
$20 from Dunkin' Donuts, Huntsville and Madison.
All you have to do is call us. At the end of the show, we'll draw from all the people who have called in, and that person wins.
534-3521 and 309-2313.
And we've added prizes. We have Rooster's Men's Grooming Center, the Club Cut, the Hot Shave, the Neck Massage. All right, so if I can move this out of the way.
Get it out of the way.
I just see my trivia. All right, so we started this yesterday, but we started it late, so we're going to pick it up today. And it's Family Feud. Family Feud. So according to a new survey, the things that Americans fear the most, out of the top 10 answers, what do you think's on the list? What do Americans fear the most? Now, remember, this is a new survey, so you have to take all that into account.
Mm-hmm.
Top 10 answers. What do you think? Phone numbers are?
256-534-3521 and 309-2313.
All right, let's go to the phone and talk to Jim. Hey, Jim.
Hey, I got the number one answer.
Okay.
Democrats.
Democrats are not on the list.
Oh, no. What kind of survey is it?
I know it.
Goodness gracious. Well, I have to go with my second choice in snakes.
Snakes, number one. Number one answer, snakes. So did you hear the story?
I think that qualifies as Democrats, doesn't it?
Same thing, rats.
Rats?
let's see here. So in San Jose... there's this guy, and me too, yeah. There's this guy who was doing a snake show. I don't know if it was at the fair or, I guess he had just finished a, let's see here. Anyway, so he's doing this show, and there are a lot of these kind of shows where they do snakes and different things, right?
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, so he, somebody went in and stole his stuff. And in one of the bags, he had snakes.
Somebody stole a bag of snakes?
Yeah, not knowing there were snakes in the bag. They were just stealing stuff, right?
That's great.
Yeah, and over the weekend. And so the thief...
returned it.
Or the theft, no. They threw the bag of snakes into like a garbage bin. I guess once they realized there were snakes in there, they threw it away, right?
Well, yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, so one in the bag, one of the snakes was a 28-inch blue-tongued lizard. What do you think about that? Yeah. Anyway,
blue-tongued lizard.
So what?
Never heard of that one.
So I guess what he had done is he had boxes and duffel bags with all his stuff. And he stacked everything up in the parking garage so he could pull his car around and load up his equipment. And when he got back, he said, in the 45 seconds to a minute and a half, I left my gear there. Somebody took my duffel bag. And in the duffel bag was the snakes.
Mm.
He was on the road doing schools, libraries, and birthday parties. Yeah, that's what I want at my birthday party. Bring the snakes and the lizards.
Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Anyway... So the police said in their report that they were afraid because there were only a few snakes left in the duffel bag, that most of them had gotten away. Mm. Now, think about that.
What about the blue-tongued lizard?
Well, I don't see. Sure.
Do I need to be on the lookout? They
don't say
if
they got that one or not. But if you see a blue-tongued lizard coming at you, you might want to. He said that was his main attraction, I guess.
I better go check my closets.
Well, it's in San Jose, so good luck.
Well, but if it ends up anywhere near Jim, Jim's going to shoot it. So.
But there is video of all these snakes and lizards, and people in San Jose are now worried that these things are out there.
Well, yeah, I would be too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But, it's basically kind of like living in Florida.
Yeah. those San Jose isn't known for that anyway.
Oh.
Go ahead.
I sent you guys an email. that I got from a friend, but it's about the Mall of America, which is in Minneapolis, Minnesota.
Yep. There was a shooting there not too long ago, a year or so ago.
But you remember, this is in the area that Omar, her area, is where the Somalis have taken over. They're now up over 100,000 Somalis in the area.
Well, and most of those are refugees that through the Obama administration, for some reason, they were bringing them refugees from Somalia. They brought huge numbers and put them all in the same place. Now, normally you don't do that with refugees. You spread them out over the United States. But like everybody else, they want to live near people like them. And you can't throw them all in the same bucket. They're not all bad. You know, a lot of them were, Somalia's a bad place.
Yeah.
But.
And this article I sent you was saying that, you know, they've taken over the Mall of America, and they do things a little bit differently. Shoplifting has gone sky high because of being able to shove a lot of stuff under their burkas. And when they bring their kids in, especially in areas that have toys, they set the kids down in the areas that have toys, and the kids unwrap and take things out of the boxes and play with them, and while the moms go off shopping, and then the moms come back and get the kids and leave the toy area a mess.
That's crazy.
Yeah. Plus the fact they don't use the regular restrooms. They go to the bathroom in the dressing rooms.
Oh. Well, so, you know, and again, you know, that's...
We had trouble out of that.
I hate to lump all that into
from immigrants in Athens.
Yeah,
not knowing where to go to the bathroom. Yeah.
But having said that,
and a lot of it has to do with they come from places where they don't have bathrooms.
Right. So whoever owns the Mall of America is allowing this to happen.
That's right.
So people in
they're probably scared.
In Minneapolis, have a choice. They don't have to shop there.
Right.
You know, so
and a lot of the store owners are closing down.
Yeah. So if they do that, then eventually the owners of the mall will do something about it. You know, we'll either have more security or curtail, you know, some of the vandalism and things like that. And you know, that's what's going to have to happen. But they'll have to do it in a, you know, capitalistic way. Mm-hmm. In order to, you know, stop any of that from happening. But there's a huge Somali presence in that area because of the refugees.
I suspect that here's a conspiracy theory for you. Let me borrow your tinfoil hat, Tony.
Mm.
I suspect that Obama dumped them all, meaning all those Somalis, in the same area. Number one, yes, they do want to be. I mean, we desegregated decades ago, but we all still hang around like people. That's the way it works. I mean, any town you go to, there's going to be an area where there's mostly black people, and there's going to be an area where it's mostly white people, because we all mingle with the same.
Right, you want to live around people that have the same.
That's why you have Chinatown and.
Well, Los Angeles is a perfect situation. East LA is mostly Latino.
Right.
South LA is mostly black. Yeah. You have Chinatown downtown.
Yeah.
Then you have North Hollywood that is mostly white.
Rich liberals.
Or the Valley area.
But.
So.
Here's the conspiracy theory. Did Obama do that, knowing that eventually we'd end up with, I mean, we already had a Muslim in there. What was his name?
Keith Ellison.
Keith Ellison.
Yeah.
But Keith Ellison was a conservative compared to this chick they got in there now. Ilhan Omar. Mm-hmm. So did Obama do that on purpose in order to get?
Yeah.
Yeah, I knew Jim would agree with me. But, hey, I mean, you've got to wonder.
Well, and that could be, but her area, her district is not 100% Somali or 100% Muslim. It's 60% and 40% white.
Okay, well, all it takes is 51% to get there.
I get that. But there are also, again, there are also people from Somalia who don't like what she's doing. So what, I'll tell you what's going to be interesting. It's going to be interesting to see in the next election.
How her re-election goes.
How her re-election goes because of everything that she's been doing. So
her and Tlaib. AOC.
Well, AOC, yeah. Tlaib's good in Detroit. She has no problem. But AOC has a problem in her district because of keeping jobs out from two or three different companies now that wanted to come in and have jobs. So it'll be interesting to see how all of this plays out. And I was trying to find that.
Timmy, while you look for that, Timmy on Facebook, this is about Syria, but he says, isolationism never works. Even though Washington said to stay away from foreign entanglements, the world involves us. The Barbary Coast pirates that Jefferson had to deal with and that is sung in the Marine Corps hymn was Muslim pirates.
Yes, they were.
Abducting and enslaving our people.
Yep.
He said, I'd like to be an isolationist, but the world won't leave us the hell alone.
Yeah, they won't. So what do you think about this situation in Syria, Jim?
Oh, that's what I was going to say next. I've got mixed feelings about it. You know, I'm all for, you know, supporting countries, but how long do you keep that up? And, you know, and then the argument against that is, well, look what we're doing in countries like Germany and Korea, that we've kept troops there forever.
Right, and we wouldn't leave. You know, we're not going to leave South Korea. We're not going to leave Germany. We're not going to leave.
We're not actively fighting over there.
Right.
There in those areas.
Right.
But are we actively fighting in Syria? See, if we just have advisors there, the Kurds are doing the fighting?
Yes, I don't know the answer to that.
All right. So one of
Trump says no.
One of
says we're not fighting. We're
Chance's friends who just joined the Marine Corps last year, his father's in Afghanistan. He said he told Chance, I think I told you this a month or so ago, that he was being deployed. And initially, he loads bombs. That's what he does.
Okay.
And that he was going to Iraq. And then Chance told me not too long ago that he was going to Syria. I said, Syria, that's his mission?
Been diverted.
I said, so maybe he'll be diverted again with this.
Maybe.
Again, I see no problem leaving people close by.
No.
So that the vacuum doesn't. Now, also, Turkey said they were going in regardless. They were going into this area, period. And I think that may be one of the reasons that Trump said we got to move our people because they could get caught up in what Turkey's about to do.
Yeah. Now, what are they wanting to go in Syria, into Syria and do? Kill the PKK?
Or whatever. Quote, unquote, Kurds, but I think it's the PKK part of the Kurds. But all of these people that the good Kurds are the 12,000 ISIS fighters and the 70,000 wives and kids, if he takes those, and my understanding is that Turkey's going to take those people, what are they going to do with them? And letting them go means that they're just going to reconstitute. They're going to get back together. And then where do they go? Because he's not going to take care of them.
You know, I don't understand all that. I don't understand why they fight each other constantly. But it's literally like taking two dominant dogs to the feeding bowl at the same time. That's how they act.
Who?
The Muslims over there. They all fight each other. It's all infighting. You know, this set of Muslims called Kurds.
Well, remember
or
that
this
Syria,
that
Assad is not a Muslim.
Okay.
Okay, so.
But Syria is a Muslim country. Just because Assad's not a Muslim,
no,
isn't it?
Actually, initially, let's see, I'm trying to remember. Initially, because he protected Christians, believe it or not, for the longest time, he was the only one who did.
Assad?
Assad, believe it or not, yes. And then it got crazy.
Most of Syria is Sunni, Muslim, 60%.
Okay. Then, so with the influx of Then I don't know what happened with him starting to bomb his own people with chemical weapons, you know. Mm-hmm. Then the then when Russia came in, and they're not Muslim.
No.
Russia's not Muslim. Mm-mm. So you have Syria and Russia. But then on the other side, you had Turkey and Iran, who hated each other up until recently when they made a bond of some sort, went and met and said, yeah, we're going to fight together.
Yep.
So it's not just Muslim. It's different sects, the Sunni and the Shia. Same thing that happened in Iraq. Sunni, Shia, you know, Kurds. Those were the main factions, and everybody was fighting each other for control of the oil. So, and the Iranians believe something totally different than the Turks do.
Yeah.
I mean, they're, so I have, but what they'll do is they'll get, all get together. I mean, wait for China to jump in there too. Right, Jim?
Of course.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, for all you retired military listeners out there, I just got notice that TRICARE mail order pharmacy for 2020 is increasing their pay by.
Few things are as important as planning for the rest of your life. It's not something you want to leave to chance, and it's not something you should undertake on your own. So lean on the trusted advice and expertise of Laura and Mike Michaels at Cochran Michaels Retirement Specialists. Visit HuntsvilleFinancial.com today to book your free one-hour consultation. That's HuntsvilleFinancial.com.
Securities offered through Cambridge Investment Research Incorporated, member FINRA SIPC. Advisory services offered through Cambridge Investment Research Advisors Incorporated. Cochran Michaels and Cambridge are not affiliated.
Have a tree that needs to come down? Call Dixieland Tree Service. Their state-of-the-art remote truck goes 98 feet in the air. It's fast, safe, and efficient. They'll treat you right and leave your lawn looking great. Call Robert Norman at Dixieland Tree Service, 256-497-8735. And follow us on Facebook.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is sponsored by Bill Penny Toyota's service department.
It's a good ride around the valley this morning. We're not spotting any problems with the weather. A great ride around Athens. No problems around Decatur. So far, 565 is moving okay, as well as your ride on Research Park Boulevard and Highway 53. No problems on the parkway heading over Chapman Mountain, looking good. No problems on 431 around Big Cove. From the traffic center, I'm Captain Carl.
Need convenient and reliable service? Bill Penny Toyota's got you covered late night, Monday through Thursday, 7 a.m. through 11 p.m. Plus, receive a lift credit and other discounts after 6 p.m. Ask for Bob. Visit BillPennyToyota.com. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
Maddie, what are you doing? How do you like the new sign? Sutton and Daughters Furniture? Does Daddy know about this? Well, we can't call it Sutton and Sons because we don't have any brothers. And besides, we've helped Daddy in the store practically since we were babies. Sutton and Daughters, that has a nice ring to it. Finally, some respect around here. Laren, this could be the start of a new trend. Either that or World War III.
The brands you trust, like Clayton Marcus and Craftmaster, at a price you'll love.
That's because Daddy said sell it.
Sutton Furniture.
Highway 72 in Athens.
For victims of drunk and drug driving, our grief is unique. But you are not alone. You always have a place at MAD. Call our 24-hour victim helpline at 877-MAD-HELP or visit MAD.org.
Talking with Russ and Andy of Last Resort Guns on County Line Road in Madison.
Membership has its perks, doesn't it?
If you take up membership in the range, your regular admission is free, so you can come in the range as often as you want. And then if you want to take part in any of the events, so training classes, there's a membership discount on all of those. And then, of course, if you're a member, the members night, which is once a month, and that's free, and we lay on snacks and drinks for the members that evening, so they get a chance to come, they can chat with one another, try out whatever we've got lined up on the day.
Visit Last Resort Guns in Madison on County Line Road, just south of Palmer Road, or give them a call today, 256-774-5741. That's Last Resort Guns.
This is WBHP Huntsville, WHOS Decatur, and WDRM-FM HD2 Decatur, Athens, Huntsville. The WBHP Morning Show continues after this Tennessee Valley News Update.
Good morning, I'm Melissa Riopko with an update from the WHNT News 19 newsroom.
The Alabama Department of Corrections is investigating an inmate death. Two officers say 35-year-old Stephen Davis rushed out of his cell Saturday at Donaldson Correctional Facility in Bessemer with a homemade weapon in each hand and tried to strike an officer. They say Davis refused to comply with verbal commands or standard methods to disarm, so the officers applied, quote, physical measures. Davis was pronounced dead at a hospital. A new industry survey projects Americans will spend $6.7 billion on pet treats by the end of the year, up $200 million over last year. And a lot of that will be spent on CBD or hemp supplements and treats, with 11% of dog owners, 8% of cat owners using them for everything from allergies to stress issues in their pets. After 18 years, iTunes is on its way out. The latest update on Apple's Mac computer replaces iTunes with separate apps for music, video, and podcasts. Those are some of the stories making headlines this Tuesday, October 8th.
Your shot at $1,000 now. Text the nationwide keyword SLED to 200-200. You'll get a confirmation text and info. Standard data and message rates apply in this nationwide contest. That's SLED to 200-200.
At Hyde Homes, we make buying a home easy. Even our phone number is easy. 256-NEW-HOME. And now we've made it even easier to buy your brand new Hyde home. Use one of our approved lenders and we will pay 100% of your closing costs and prepaids. All you need is $500 down and that's all. So pick up the phone and give us a call today at 256-NEW-HOME. Or visit us online at hyde-homes.com. Call us now. 256-NEW-HOME.
Football was made for Beignet Cafe. Crank up your game day with spicy jambalaya and an ice cold beer for the win. Two locations in Northeast Huntsville and in Madison on Hughes Road. At Beignet Cafe, you can enjoy breakfast, brunch, lunch, and weekend dinners featuring New Orleans-inspired foods with a southern flair, like our signature Dirty Grits and, of course, our freshly prepared beignets. We also feature live music in Madison. Like us on Facebook for a schedule of performers. It's always a great sunny day at Beignet Cafe.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is sponsored by Bill Penny Toyota's service department.
It's a good ride around the valley this morning. We're not spotting any problems with the weather. A great ride around Athens. No problems around Decatur. So far, 565 is moving okay, as well as your ride on Research Park Boulevard and Highway 53. No problems on the parkway. Heading over Chapman Mountain looking good. No problems on 431 around Big Cove. From the traffic center, I'm Captain Carl.
Need convenient and reliable service? Bill Penny Toyota's got you covered late night, Monday through Thursday, 7 a.m. through 11 p.m. Plus, receive a lift credit and other discounts after 6 p.m. Ask for Bob. Visit BillPennyToyota.com. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
Say good morning to Roger House, APS, Alabama Professional Services. Roger, what are the clues that you can see in your house? There might be something wrong with their foundation.
Cracks in the concrete. I was up here the other day. I had one where the inside of the garage has fallen, and it had a 3-inch gap in it from the wall. So we had to jack it back up. But you have to look at that. I mean, uneven concrete, cracking wall, bricks cracked, freeze board, the very top board on your house has moved out about 3 inches or something like that because the house has fallen.
And how do you fix that?
We have products, push piers, helical piers, where we can jack the house back up. We go in, we put these in the ground, we put brackets on the main foundation, and we drive it to load-bearing strata and pick up on the house.
If you leave it and let it go, then you could have major problems, couldn't you?
It could get very expensive if you leave it alone. I mean, very expensive. Yeah. You could look at a side of a house falling off, brick falling off. If you ever go to sell your house, nobody will buy it because of the foundation issues.
Call APS Foundation Services today, 256-417-4293. Or go to AlabamaProfessionalServices.com. And ask Roger.
Say good morning to Janet Kincherlow-Martin. Let's talk about dual enrollment.
A high school student can get dual credit for being enrolled in a class. They can get high school credit and college credit. We're finding that more and more high schools are taking interest, more and more students and their parents are taking interest, because what is happening is that because they're getting dual credit, lots of times we're finding now that when a student graduates from high school, they're also graduating from college with a 2-year degree. If they're transferring, they're starting their junior year at 18 years old, or a lot of them are going into industry and working and making very good salaries at 18 and 19 years old.
And you get scholarships.
You can get scholarships for those areas that lead to a job. For instance, welding, machine tool technology, nursing. If the program leads to a job, then there's money from the state to scholarship those students.
That's something everybody ought to be taking
really,
advantage
of. Because you're getting free tuition, you're getting dual credit, high school and college credit. If you start early enough in your high school career, as soon as you're eligible to take dual enrollment classes, you can possibly get a job at 18 years old making $50,000, $60,000 a year.
Log on to calhoun.edu to register today.
Real news.
So Bernie Sanders actually had a heart attack.
He had a
heart attack.
That'll nix his campaign.
He was discharged Friday from the hospital. He's down in the polls, but that's not because of the heart attack. That's because he's so angry all the time. So he says he feels great. He's going to be on the debate stage.
Honest opinion.
We're liable to see a medical, and instead of it being Hillary falling and coughing and stuff, Bernie's liable to have a medical emergency live on TV.
And a dash of humor just for fun. Awarded best talk show in the state of Alabama by the Alabama Broadcasters Association. This is the WBHP Morning Show. Now, here's your host, Tony Lowry, with Corey Moss.
Welcome into the Morning Show at 6:07. Call us. Phone numbers are
256-534-3521. And 309-2313.
So what we fear, according to a new survey, things that Americans fear the most, snakes number one. Some of these are a little weird. Some aren't, but some are, you know, not what I would consider being, you know, top of mind. But it's a new survey. So what do you think's on the list? Snakes number one. What else? What are you afraid of? What do you fear the most? Call us. Phone numbers one more time.
256-534-3521 and 309-2313.
All right. So, you know, from day one, I've said that the IG, the intelligence community inspector general, that there was something off there.
Mm-hmm.
Because he hadn't even read the transcript before he sent over the complaint to Congress.
Right.
And then we had the story where the rules had been changed from where you had to have firsthand knowledge if you were a whistleblower to you could have secondhand knowledge, water cooler talk, didn't matter, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Whatever.
And then there were stories saying, well, no, the rules haven't changed. Those were always the rules.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's what they were saying. Well, it looks like, you know, he was behind closed doors, and this is why this whole thing is bogus. Instead of the judiciary, Jerry Nadler, having these hearings in open court so the American people can see, Pelosi gave it to Schiff, the Intelligence Committee, to handle these investigations. That's not happened before. It was always the judiciary, so you could have
hearings.
Well,
that's where it ought to be.
Yes. And because it's in the intel, the House intel under Schiff, all the testimony is behind closed doors so that the American people can't hear it. Democrats can leak what they want, which is what they've done. And because there's no vote, Republicans can't really participate. They can't issue subpoenas themselves. They can't call witnesses themselves. And they're told what questions they can ask.
And the president can't defend himself.
And the president, there's no due process. The whole thing is wrong.
Yep.
According to our Constitution. Now, so the Intel Community Inspector General, Michael Atkinson, was behind closed doors Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Testifying, right?
Yep.
And my understanding is, according to Devin Nunes, is he stonewalled lawmakers during that testimony. Because he refused to explain how or why the whistleblower form was changed. Now, there's a couple of things on this form. There are stories saying that we're talking about whistleblower number one, okay? That he did not mark either of the boxes. I have firsthand knowledge, or I have somebody told me.
Okay. Well, that's an incomplete form.
He did not tell, allegedly, the inspector general that he had already contacted Adam Schiff's staff. So Adam Schiff lied about all that. He went on the air. We have several sound bites of him saying, well, we don't know. We don't know who he is, and he didn't contact any of our people. When he did, he contacted the Schiff's committee first before he contacted the inspector general. And so if the IG gutted the whistleblower complaint form in September and changed it to include secondhand knowledge and basically water cooler gossip to support allegations of misconduct, there's another report out there. There's another report out there that the inspector general then backdated the whistleblower rules to allow the complaint form filled out by the CIA, the whistleblower number one, on August 12th to qualify under the new rules. So if the story is correct, that the IG changed the rules or updated the website to show the rules in September, then, and the complaint was put out, you know, was issued in August, then the IG would have had to backdate the whistleblower rules and allow the complaint form filled out by the whistleblower to qualify. So, according to the Federalist,
it wouldn't be backdate's not the right word. He retroactively or something.
Same thing.
Because backdating would mean you had to put a date older. He would have to put a date newer.
No. He would have had to put a date older because the...
So the guy complained in August.
Right. And
he changed the rules or whatever on the website in September. Well, that would be not backdating, but front dating.
Well, he would have had to change the rules where it said that they went into effect in August instead of September.
Oh, he's backdating the rule change.
The rule change.
All
yes.
Right. I've got the wrong thing being backdated.
Okay. So if he backdated the rule change
yes.
to August so that this complaint could go forward.
I got you now. Mm-hmm.
Is what Nunes is saying. And according to the Federalist, it, quote, intense testimony before the House Permanent Select Committee on Intelligence, the inspector general refused to disclose why his office backdated secret changes to key whistleblower forms and rules in the wake of the whistleblower complaint filed in August.
How can you not give over that information?
He refused. Because it's, see, if Republicans were able to ask the questions they needed to ask, if it was in an open hearing, he would have had to, you know, they would have pounded him in public.
Well, I'm sure they pounded him in private.
But it's in private. So that's why we need the transcript of the hearing released, declassified and released, so the American people can read it. So he told lawmakers during this committee hearing that the whistleblower forms and rule change were made in September. He told them that. So all these stories saying that it had been done back in May, blah, blah, blah. Even though the new forms and guidance, which were not uploaded to the website until September 24th, and state they were changed in August. That's what it says now. Despite having a full week to come up with explanations for his office's decisions to secretly change its forms to eliminate the requirement for firsthand evidence, and to backdate those changes to August, he refused to provide any explanation to lawmakers.
What did he say when somebody said, why did you and when did you change this whatever he changed? I mean, what did he say? Did he say, well, I'm not going to talk about that? Or, I mean, how did he refuse?
Well,
of course, August, we know
so
that,
he but. Put, you know, he had put out a statement a couple of weeks ago that says, in June 2019, the newly hired director for the Center for Protected Disclosures entered on duty. Thus, the Center for Protected Disclosures, I guess that's a whistleblower, right?
Mm-hmm.
Has been reviewing the forms provided to whistleblowers who wish to report information with respect to an urgent concern to the Congressional Intelligence Committees.
Well, who'd they hire, James Comey?
In the process of reviewing and clarifying those forms, and in response to recent press inquiries regarding the instant whistleblower complaint, The ICIG, the Inspector General for the Intelligence, understood that certain language in those forms, and more specifically, the informational materials accompanying the forms, could be read incorrectly, as suggesting that whistleblowers must possess firsthand information in order to file an urgent concern complaint with the Congressional Intelligence Committee. So they changed it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, they may have changed it, but according to this new guy, right, that says, well, you don't have to have firsthand information. Otherwise, it's hearsay, for goodness sakes.
Right.
Hearsay. So,
and would not be permitted in any real court of law.
Because in the initial one, it says that you have to have firsthand knowledge and you have to have some proof. Right. You can't just come in and say, because then it'd be a he said, she said, they said, right? So having said all that, and the fact that he won't, so where's the DNI? Why isn't he making him? You know, he's the inspector general under the director of a national intelligence, the new guy that testified, right? Why isn't he making him answer these questions?
Can he do that?
I don't know. Maybe he has total anonymity.
Yeah,
I don't know.
He may have autonomy.
Yeah. So, but there are questions why he did this, why he backdated this. And
he won't answer any questions.
And if the... if the whistleblower number one actually marked, I have firsthand knowledge, and then came out with a complaint that he didn't, that's a federal crime in itself, lying on the form. Okay, move forward to whistleblower number two. They keep saying that a whistleblower number two has come forward, but no complaint has come forward.
Nope.
All of the media, every single one of them, Fox News, everyone is saying, we now have second whistleblower.
But the only thing different from this whistleblower, from everything I've heard or read, is he says he has firsthand knowledge of the phone call. Well, so do we.
We have the transcript.
So we don't need a second whistleblower on that. If you want to try to add another whistleblower, Democrats,
well,
go right ahead. But change the subject.
It may be that this is the guy who told whistleblower number one.
That's what I figured.
The information.
Yeah.
Right? So he's going to corroborate the information from whistleblower number one.
Okay, but
wait,
who cares?
But wait a minute. See, but
he's going to corroborate lies?
But here's where the fake is in.
Mm-hmm.
Whistleblower number one says he has knowledge, right?
Yes.
Then a complaint is sent to, a formal complaint is sent to the Intelligence Committee, right?
Yep.
There's been no formal complaint. They just keep saying there's a second whistleblower. Where's the complaint? You remember it was declassified, released to everybody so they could see what was in the complaint?
We don't need another whistleblower on this.
No, but you're missing my point. You're missing my point. If there is indeed, quote-unquote...
No, you want him to file a report. Well, I got you.
Well, no, that's not it. I'm talking about how they're scamming your brain. Okay, so they come out and
say... scamming my brain.
I know that. Will you let me talk? So they have... If they're saying there's a second whistleblower, there has to be a formal complaint. And if there's no formal complaint, guess what? They don't have a second whistleblower.
We got that, Tony.
But the American people are thinking there's a second whistleblower.
Well, American people's dumb.
Well, regardless, that's where that's where the additional scam is coming in, is there is, at this point, there is no second whistleblower.
Now, there has been no more paperwork filed.
Nope.
And he didn't have any new information.
No.
From what I've gathered.
No.
Aside from him, he said he had firsthand knowledge. Well, so do we now.
Yes, we have the transcript of the call.
So that's why I say, Democrats, if you want to trot out another whistleblower, go ahead. But you're going to change subjects to something else, some other phone call.
Well, but they're not. And they're not even putting out the complaint that what he, you know, the first whistleblower had the whatever law firm, probably his law firm, make that first complaint. But there hasn't been a complaint. So how many whistleblowers
can you... You're hung up on that, aren't you?
How many... Well, it's just that... Well, it's, let me tell you what it reminds me. It reminds me of Kavanaugh.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's a complaint from Blasey Ford.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's... Oh, we have three more allegations, right? And remember, the whistleblower is still an allegation. Hasn't been proven. Nothing's been proven that there's anything different than the phone call.
No, the first whistleblower, his allegations have been proven false.
Yes.
Many of them.
Yeah. So how many allegations can you trot out there without any kind of, without even a complaint or any proof of anything that went wrong? The media has zeroed in on, there's a second whistleblower, but there's no complaint. So how do you know there's a second whistleblower, just because somebody said so? Anyway, so now they want to take, and I think I told you this last week, now they want to take this quote-unquote whistleblower to a secret location and not allow Republicans in.
Yep.
Just Democrats can question the whistleblower, and they'll have his voice configured and his a mask on him or something like that, so nobody can tell who he is. But no Republicans No Republicans allowed to question him. So I think it's time that Republicans, I don't know what they're afraid of, get out there and start talking about this, because how do you have, you know, in the Nixon and Clinton, they worked together. Mm-hmm. Democrats and Republicans worked together in Congress to have the right committees. Everybody had their shot at their the Republicans didn't keep the Democrats out of the Clinton impeachment hearings.
Those were legitimate impeachment complaints.
Well, this is not. No. You can't just, because I said so, say, right. Well, there's an impeachment, official impeachment inquiry.
Yep.
Doesn't happen that way. There's more. We'll get to all of that. Let's go to David. Hey, David.
Hey, good morning, Tony.
Hey.
It doesn't sound like there's transparency in government, does it?
Not at all, especially if you're going to interview the whistleblower number one with no Republicans allowed in.
Right.
How do you even do that?
Yeah.
Jeez.
Well, when you're in control, you do whatever you want to do.
I guess.
Right. On the fear thing, how about fear of crowds?
Fear of crowds is on there, number 9 on the list. Very good.
Okay.
Yep.
All right.
Thank you.
Morning.
You too. And Marilyn. Hey, Marilyn.
How about the fear of clowns?
Clowns is on there, number 7.
Cool.
Yeah.
Thanks.
They're kind of scary. Thank you, Marilyn. All right, we'll take a break. We'll be back. Don't go away.
On your smartphone, download the free iHeartRadio app and listen anywhere in the U.S.
And listen on your computer free anywhere in the world.
And we're on HD Radio 102.1-2.
Listen to WBHP on your Amazon Echo. Just say, Alexa, play WBHP on iHeartRadio.
And don't forget to like our Facebook page, facebook.com/Tony and Gary.
It's the morning show with Tony and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
And now on 102.5 FM.
Say good morning to Mike Holt, Holt Siding and Replacement Windows. Mike, tell us what you do.
We install vinyl siding, energy-efficient replacement windows, gutters, shutters, just anything that will go do with exterior upgrades to your home. You know, a lot of times people say, well, I've got good windows. I've got storm windows. But the deal is you don't have the low-E argon glass-filled windows. You don't have the energy-efficient windows. And comparison to what the windows we put in with the energy efficiency compared to what people have had in their homes originally, it's almost like having a hole in your wall. You just don't realize the difference until you have them. The comfort, it saves you money. It's an upgrade cosmetically from your curb appearance. It's just a good investment for your home. And it's not just having the windows, it's having them installed properly, too. I'll put our installation people and our procedures installation up with anybody, anywhere. We really have guys that know what they're doing. They've been doing this like I have for years. They just enjoy installing windows. That's what they do. That's what they like.
Call for your free estimate today. Holtz Siding and Replacement Windows, 256-288-0050.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is sponsored by Bill Penny Toyota's service department.
So far, it's a good ride around the valley, around Hazel Green, Meridianville, heading up and down the parkway, heading over Chapman Mountain. You're looking good there. Traffic looking good on Research Park Boulevard, Highway 53 around Harvest moving okay. No problems around Athens on Highway 72, Highway 31. So far, a good ride on 565 and around Decatur. From the Traffic Center, I'm Captain Carl.
Need convenient and reliable service? Bill Penny Toyota's got you covered late night, Monday through Thursday, 7 a.m. through 11 p.m. Plus, receive a lift credit and other discounts after 6 p.m. Ask for Bob. Visit BillPennyToyota.com. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
Hey, it's me, your cell phone. We need to talk about something. Something serious. I know you love me. I know you like using me wherever you are, but I feel like this isn't working out when you're driving. I know you may think that it's possible to focus both on me and the road, but I just don't feel the same way. I think we should spend time away from each other when you're driving. It's for the best.
StopTextStopWrecks.org. A message brought to you by iHeartRadio, the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, and the Ad Council.
Get in on the conversation. Call the WBHP Morning Show now at 256-534-3521 or 309-2313.
Hi, I'm Kerry Rosenbloom with Rosenbloom Realty, and if this year may be your year to consider selling your home, then contact us at Rosenbloom Realty. We have the latest details of the real estate market, can give you a free assessment of your home's value and the advice on marketing it. Call us at 256-539-9501 or visit us at rosenbloomrealty.com and let us put our years of experience to work for you in selling your home this year.
From the Yellowhammer Roofing Weather Center.
Now, your official WBHP Weather Center forecast.
This report is sponsored by Mattress Firm.
I'm WHNT News 19 meteorologist Ben Smith. Scattered cloud cover around through the afternoon. Could be a couple of isolated showers. Otherwise, a cool afternoon with highs in the upper 70s. Partly cloudy tonight, down into the upper 50s. And for tomorrow, a warmer afternoon. Only an isolated shower for Wednesday with highs in the mid-80s. Take my forecast and WBHP with you everywhere. Download the iHeartRadio app at WBHP1025.com.
At Mattress Firm, for a limited time, take home a free adjustable base with purchase of $699. Plus, get up to $400 in savings and enjoy 0% APR for 6 years. Zero down and zero due at signing. Shop the Save Big Sale online or in store.
ADP isn't just in the payroll business. We're in the people business, helping companies find them, train them, and empower them by clearing the way for them to do their best work. Because when your people thrive, your business thrives with them. HR, talent, time, benefits, and payroll. Informed by data and designed for people, so you and your company can achieve what you're working for. Learn more at design.adp.com.
Lowe's has the supplies pros use most every day. And when the job demands more, we're stocked with the quantities needed for any size job. It's savings you can count on. Because when you buy in bulk, you'll get 10% off all drywall and drywall accessories. Purchase 64 or more sheets of OSB and you'll also save 10%. Order ahead at lowesforpros.com and we'll have your order ready for pickup. Our pro loaders will be ready to load you up so you can get back to the job site. Do it right for less. Start with Lowe's. U.S. only.
From iHeartRadio, number one for podcasts, Bear and a Banjo.
Bear and Banjo, the two most important musicians of the 20th century. Podcast narrated by Dennis Quaid. Featuring new music produced by T-Bone Burnett. Written by Jared Gustin and Grammy-winning songwriter Pooh Bear Boyd. With a new song featuring original lyrics by Bob Dylan.
WBHP is available everywhere you want to listen on our free iHeartRadio app. Download it now.
Yeah!
I'm Kerry Rosenbloom with Rosenbloom Realty. This year just may be the year that you need to make that transition from one home to another. We're here to make that happen for you at Rosenbloom Realty. We have the experience of over 60 years to give you to make that transition hassle-free. Give us a call today at 256-539-9501 or visit us on our website at rosenbloomrealty.com and we'll make it happen for you.
Thank you, Kerry. Welcome back to the morning show, 629. So just to finish up on this, because I've done a lot of investigative work into the IG, and it looks like that he was involved, he's been involved in a lot of different things. Now, he was nominated, I mean, he was appointed or whatever by Trump, another one of those, hey, what about this guy?
Mm-hmm.
But if he did indeed refuse, again, we need to see the transcript, refuse to answer those questions and change the whistleblower, you know, firsthand knowledge requirement.
We got to have a way to get those answers. I mean, that's a policy question that shouldn't be hidden.
Right, because if he did what we just said, and without, you know, remember, he never read the transcript of the phone call. And so it looks like if it's, you know, if everything's based on hearsay now And this whistleblower never informed the IG about prior contact and coordination with Adam Schiff and his people. And the CIA operative, the whistleblower, never disclosed congressional contact at all on the complaint form, because it asks you on the complaint form if you've had any correspondence with anybody else. Then the complaint forms were changed specifically to accommodate him. Then the IG is in on it. And I said that from day one.
So does the new complaint form include the question, have you spoken to Pencil Neck Schiff?
No, but it does say, have you spoken, something to the effect of, have you spoken to anybody else? You know, which he...
And he said no.
Well, apparently he said no. So...
Well, that's a false report.
That's a federal crime.
Yes.
And so, if this is indeed true, and the IG never reviewed the call transcript, and yet facilitated the complaint with numerous flaws, and the fact that both the Director of National Intelligence, the DNI, and the Department of Justice Office of Legal Counsel highlighted his poor decision-making in forwarding it to Schiff because it didn't have all the requirements. Well, you know, because McGuire was, President Trump announced McGuire's acting DNI on August 8th, and the CIA operative, the whistleblower, the letter to Schiff and Burr, Republican in the Senate, was on August 12th. And immediately following that letter, the Inspector General and requirements for urgent concern whistleblowers was modified, allowing hearsay complaints. And then on August 28th, Schiff begins tweeting about the construct, basically, of the complaint. And given the nature of Atkins's background, the IG, in his prior work in 2016 has now come out.
What was he doing then?
Well, that's a whole nother ball game, because it looks like he had a lot to do with some of the people. Well, for example, he was Atkinson was the lawyer for the players who lied to the FISA court, and the same people who filed the FISA application against Carter Page and used FARA violations for surveillance. So he was involved in all that. Spygate.
He was involved in spying on the president, and the president has appointed him to something?
Well, again, whoever told him to nominate this guy, I'm just saying.
All right, President Trump. You're going with your gut with this military stuff, and I'm fine with that as long as you don't screw up. Can you please go with your gut on appointing people?
Well, he can't. See, here's the problem. He can't oversee every single appointment. And he relies on these people to tell him who's a good guy to put in there. And they put in a guy that's been involved in the FISA applications and warrants in 2016.
Two and three quarters years. Doesn't he know he can't trust those people?
Well, who can he trust then?
Hell, I don't know.
He can't oversee every appointment. Who can he trust? I'm not sure he can trust the act. I told you this from the hearing. The acting DNI said the inspector general did everything right.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, he didn't.
Now, he's one of those who likes to go along to get along.
Yes.
And pay niceties to people who are doing things wrong.
He's going
to
back up his staff and,
yeah,
you know, he's...
And I'm fine with that.
Yes, except...
Until the staff really did something wrong.
Yes. You know? So, I'm just saying that, here we go again with all these people who are involved in 2016 are now still there. And are involved in the whistleblower thing? Again, back to whistleblower number two. We don't even know if there's a whistleblower. I know they said there was. But so far, a complaint has not been made.
So you're saying they might be making that up?
Well, that's what I'm saying. Until you see a complaint, how long has it been now since they said whistleblower number two has come forward? All the media.
Whistleblower, it's been a while.
Second whistleblower has come forward. Okay, where's the complaint? Yeah. What did he says he has firsthand knowledge. Firsthand knowledge of what?
I heard Britt Baer say last night on Special Report, this is what he said. It's close to verbatim. The second whistleblower, who says he has first-hand knowledge of the Ukraine call and maybe more,
Right. That's right.
And what maybe, about maybe more?
Okay. What is the maybe more?
Yeah.
So let's
if
hear
if there's
it.
Maybe more,
where's
let's
the complaint?
File a complaint.
Yeah.
If you can, legally, you know, without lying on it like the first one did.
And then the president can declassify it and we can read it.
We can see that.
Again, sure. We have no transparency. We don't know what's going on. Everything's behind closed doors. And the Republicans are being kept out.
The CIA, and I don't guess the FBI is involved in this, but I'll lump them into it, and the FBI have brought all of this cynicism
on themselves.
And skepticism on themselves.
Yes.
By the way they've acted.
Absolutely.
So I'm sorry. Because I've, listen here, it's taken me a long time to get to this spot where I'm second-guessing my government. I've always loved this country, still do. And loved our government for the most part, and trusted them with everything in me, but that's gone.
Up until 2016, and we found out and we reported on in 2016 all the things that the FBI, the Strzok's, the Page, the and then into the Mueller report and all of that, and mm-hmm. the Comeys and the McCabes, and then all those other people, the Nellie Orr at Fusion GPS and her husband at the DOJ, Bruce Orr, and their transcripts of their testimony and things. I mean, there's so many people involved in this. We never would have thought that they, you know, we thought all that was done away with back decades ago when it was really bad.
Yeah, with
blacklists.
Hoover and all.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But I think Schumer's right when he says what? What did Schumer say?
You take on the intelligence community, they have six ways from Sunday at getting back at you.
You have six ways a Sunday of getting back. That was January 2017.
And the CIA perked up and said, "Why, yes, we
do,
Chucky."
We'll take a break. We'll be back. Don't go away.
WBHP.
The unemployment rate is lower than it's been in decades. That means if you're trying to hire a new employee, they probably already have a job, which means you need to try reaching them in a different way. That's where iHeartMedia comes in. Every week, our radio stations reach 93% of the U.S., most likely when they're on their commute or already at work. So start connecting with the qualified candidates you've been looking for on AM/FM radio. Visit iHeartWorks.com. That's iHeartWorks.com.
It's happening. Wherever cupcakes are being frosted, songs are being recorded, and engines are being tuned, ADP is designing a better way to work. With industry-leading HR, talent, time, benefits, and payroll, more companies rely on ADP than any other HR partner. From small business to global enterprise, see how ADP can help you and your people achieve what you're working for at design.adp.com. ADP, always designing for people.
Weather hits. The right wiper blades make all the difference. That's when the Michelin man is on your side, helping you see better and drive safer with new Michelin premium wiper blades. Designed with exclusive SmartFlex technology, a frameless beam design, Michelin blades flex to the curve of your windshield, giving you unparalleled streak-free, long-lasting all-season performance. So when the going gets tough, be ready with Michelin premium wiper blades. It's a difference you can see. Available at Walmart, Pep Boys, Amazon, and other fine retailers.
For victims of drunk and drug driving, our grief is unique. But you are not alone. You always have a place at MAD. Call our 24-hour victim helpline at 877-MAD-HELP or visit MAD.org.
Want to qualify for today's huge prize package? Call the WBHP Morning Show now at 256-534-3521 or 309-2313.
Train presents The Unstoppables. Those captains of comfort who let nothing overcome their profound profession. Those gargantuans of the guarantee. Those comfort kings with a tireless tenacity for total turnaround. The train comfort specialists. Just one more reason why it's hard to stop a train.
Call Bo Thomas, your train comfort specialist. 256-858-4822. Or go to coolhuntsville.com. Thomas HVAC. It's hard to stop a train.
You'll finally get to do what you
you want to do. In retirement, you can travel, golf, spend time with the grandkids, maybe just relax at home. But you do have to plan for it. Start by tuning in to Chris Wallace of WG Financial Group every Saturday afternoon from 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and then Sunday mornings at 9 for Your Retirement Matters. Make retirement the best time of your life. Tune in Saturdays from 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and Sundays at 9 for Your Retirement Matters with Chris Wallace. Investment advisory services offered only by duly registered individuals through AE Wealth Management, LLC.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is sponsored by Bill Penny Toyota's service department.
Well, good news. If you have to be on the road this morning, it's a quiet ride so far. It's early as folks are just starting to get on the road. We're not spotting any problems around Athens. Things are moving okay around Decatur and heading over the Hudson Memorial Bridge. No problems on 565 around the Space and Rocket Center. So far, a good ride coming up from Lacey's Spring and heading over Chapman Mountain 72. You're looking good there. From the Traffic Center, I'm Captain Carl.
Need convenient and reliable service? Bill Penny Toyota's got you covered late night, Monday through Thursday, 7 a.m. through 11 p.m. Plus, receive a Lyft credit and other discounts after 6 p.m. Ask for Bob. Visit BillPennyToyota.com. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
The Lyosi Group has been taking care of your office needs for over 40 years. They've also been saving 95% of their customers' money and improving efficiency. In this economy, people don't want to think about buying office equipment, but the Lyosi Group is reducing hard dollar cost for their customers. How? The machines do more and cost less. Lexmark copiers revolutionize how copies, prints, scans, and faxes are made. Don't be afraid to check into saving your company money. The Lyosi Group is where you'll receive quality service guaranteed, response time guaranteed. That means guaranteed satisfaction. Call the Lyosi Group to start reducing your office costs today.
Service. Extraordinary service. Just ask anyone. 650-4150. Lyosi.
Listen to WBHP on your Amazon Echo. Just say, Alexa, play WBHP on iHeartRadio.
Welcome back to the morning show. Okay, what are we giving away?
$40 for Popeye's Cajun Fried Chicken. Movie passes for two at Hollywood 18. $20 from Dunkin' Donuts, Huntsville and Madison.
All you have to do is call us. At the end of the show, we'll draw from all the people who have called in, and that person wins.
534-3521 and 309-2313.
All right, so trivia. Welcome back to the morning show, 642. We have, according to a new survey, what are the top 10 things Americans fear the most? Let's see what we have here. Crowds, clowns, snakes so far.
All right.
Some of these are a little odd. So what do you think? And what are you afraid of? We'd love to hear from you about that. And then it is...
The government. that ain't on there, is it?
I know. That is not on there.
I'm sorry.
It's World Octopus Day. So all the answers, I'm going to give you two quizzes. Oh. So it is, if you have one, you know, just pet it, feed it. All the answers end in us, U.S.
An octopus?
I don't know.
I'm going to eat one for lunch, I think.
This creature has the largest mouth among land mammals. Ends in U.S., us.
Hmm.
Planet discovered by William Herschel. Planet discovered by William Herschel ends in U.S.
Okay. I guess I know that one.
A desert plant. A vegetable of the lily family, which I had no idea. Let me see what else is in here. Mold or yeast or mushrooms ends in U.S.
Uh-huh.
And we'll start with those. All right, phone numbers again.
256-534-3521 and 309-2313.
Let's go to the phone and talk to David. Hey, David.
Hello. I had one of the fears. How about over-engineered buildings, also known as a complex?
What? You must be an engineer.
No, but I tried.
All right, David, you're in there, though.
All right, thanks.
Uh-huh. And Alice, hey, Alice.
one of your answers hippopotamus?
It is hippopotamus. That would be the creature that has the largest mouth among land mammals. That would
be it. Okay, that sounds like me.
Oh, jeez. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
All right, so The Joker was a big movie over the weekend.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. One knew it would be. You know, probably. The Joker, the new movie, The Joker?
Yeah.
Yeah. Because, you know, but it got a lot of publicity, that's for sure. But for all of those who still don't believe that TDS is real.
TDS?
Yes.
Trump Derangement Syndrome?
Yes. Mm-hmm. You can look at the CNN op-ed from Sunday. And it's titled Joker, A Political Parable for Our Times. Jeff Yang wrote this. And he basically is trying to put Trump and the Joker as the same person. It's all about Trump and white male resentment. I'm just saying. What?
Well, there is white male resentment in this country.
Yes, but that's what created the Joker and his, he's a maniac, crazy.
Well, no, the Joker's been around since when white guys were okay to have around.
Yes, but what they're saying is what turned the Joker into a maniac killer was white male resistance.
Except he's always been a maniac killer.
Yes, even back in the 60s when they had the Batman thing on TV.
TV series.
Yeah.
Now, it wasn't as gruesome or as nasty or ugly, but he was still a killer.
Yeah. Well, leave it to CNN to try to make that connection. Right after CNN said, oh, this is really bad because there could be copycats. So, just saying. And Oliver Stone, back in, I haven't had a chance to watch all the video, but it's back in 2014, Oliver Stone did interviews over in the Ukraine.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like Biden was mentioned in some of those.
Oh.
Yeah. It'll take me a little while to actually listen to all of those. Let's get to Tricia. Hey, Tricia.
Good morning. One of your trivia answers would be cactus.
Cactus, it is. That ends in U.S. Very good.
Bye.
Some good news. You wouldn't think it's good news, but it is good news. Police have arrested more than twice the number of domestic ISIS terrorists and sympathizers in the first 8 months of this year than they did in all of 2018. The bad news is we have more. It's on the increase, ISIS terrorism. The good news is we're getting them. So they've arrested 24 people for ISIS-related offenses as of September 3rd.
Hmm.
And
where at?
Let's see. I don't have a list, I don't think, of all of them. But I can get a list. But it looks like we're now doing more in getting them out and arresting them. I'll get a list. I thought this had a list, but it doesn't. I'll have a list for you tomorrow. Have you heard about this thing that happened in Tuscaloosa? So we talked to the Secretary of State about this. Alabama hospital system pays scammers that are behind the ransomware attack.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So they paid off these hackers that took three local hospital computer systems hostage using ransomware. And they say the payouts is what fuels the drive. But what do you do? So if they take your information, all of your patient information, everything, if they take it hostage and say, and basically what they're saying, and this has been going on for a long time, you know, same thing happened to Sony and other places, and they say, hey, we have locked down your computers, you can't do anything until you pay us in Bitcoin,
right?
So it can't be traced.
Yep.
What do you do? You can't, some really smart person out there needs to figure out how to unhack these things and they would make a fortune.
You know, there ought to be a way. I was thinking about that the other day. There ought to be a way. Of course, you'll have to continuously evolve how you do it, but there ought to be a way to where if information gets put on a device that it's not meant to be on, there ought to be a way for it to, quote-unquote, self-destruct.
Or don't you have backups?
Well, yeah, I'm sure they got backups, but that's not the problem. You having the information is not the problem. It's the hacker having that information. Backups simply make sure you don't lose that information. The hackers don't care whether you keep it or not. They just want a copy of it. That's what I'm saying.
Well, when
it would self-destruct, quote-unquote, whatever you would call that,
I see.
Then they wouldn't have that information, but you still would.
Well, they're saying they had backups.
Yeah.
I'm sure.
But backups doesn't keep...
To rebuild certain systems.
Right. Backups doesn't keep the hackers from getting your social security numbers.
Yeah, what they got was direct patient information.
Yeah. So there ought to be a way. Brian, you're an IT genius. Come up with a way to make this information... Whatever the word is I'm looking for, I'm using the term self-destruct. That way, if once it gets off of the intended devices, then it can't be accessed. It seems to me like that would keep, at least be a start.
Well, there's got to be some way out of this where they don't, like I say, three hospitals on lockdown, basically, because they can't do anything.
Right. And then they end up paying it.
Yeah, and they end up paying to get out of it.
How much they'd have to pay? Have you seen?
Mm-hmm. They won't tell.
Yeah.
But if nobody paid, then they wouldn't be.
Oh, of course.
Doing it. It's knowing that they have to pay.
Probably. Well, I was going to say you work on the power of 10. You know, one out of 10 is going to do it. In this situation, probably more than one out of 10
would
do
bet.
It.
Mm-hmm. Let's go to Miranda. Hey, Miranda.
Hey, good morning.
Good morning.
Hey, is one of your answers cactus?
It is cactus. That ends in the U.S. Desert plant. Very good, Miranda.
Awesome. Have a good day.
So, you know, the Supreme Court started their session October 1st,
mm-hmm.
and one of their first cases, it looks like Justice Thomas was absent, sick.
Oh, no.
But it looks like he just has the flu.
Oh, good.
So, hopefully, he doesn't need to get sick, bad sick. But, no. You know, they've got a lot to look at, abortion, immigration.
Take one of those super secret pills that they all take.
You know, you and your super secret pills. According to USA Today, this is interesting. Americans 2-1 favor investigation of Biden's dirty deals.
Well.
Yeah. From the USA Today, really? All right. We'll get back to it. Don't go away.
WBHP. The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is sponsored by Bill Penny Toyota's service department.
A lot more cars, trucks, and school buses on the road this morning, already crowded on 516 heading eastbound approaching Mooresville Road. Some heavy traffic there. No problems right now on the parkway. Heading over Chapman Mountain, you're looking good there. 431 looking good around Big Cove. No problems on 72 out through Athens. From the traffic center, I'm Captain Carl.
Need convenient and reliable service? Bill Penny Toyota's got you covered late night, Monday through Thursday, 7 a.m. through 11 p.m. Plus, receive a lift credit and other discounts after 6 p.m. Ask for Bob. Visit BillPennyToyota.com. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
Say good morning to Keith Pinkerton. He is Mr. Electric. Now, Keith, every month we have severe weather in the Tennessee Valley. Power outages, a big problem. But you can help stop that.
That is correct. We can actually come in and install a whole house generator that automatically senses when the power goes off, takes you off the utility grid, and turns on the generator and powers up your house during a power outage. And when it power comes back on, it senses it and shuts down the generator and puts you back on the utility grid.
And another important feature with Mr. Electric is making sure you're safe at home.
We actually have a home safety inspection, electrical home safety inspection that we do when we come out to your house. And, and we inspect your whole electrical system and we educate you about your electrical system. And if we see any code violations or anything that needs to be addressed, we'll give you a free upfront quote.
Call Mr. Electric today. 256-536-8119.
W273-CX Huntsville.
All money managers might seem the same, but while some give their clients cookie-cutter portfolios, Fisher Investments tailors portfolios to your goals and needs. Some only call when they have something to sell. Fisher calls regularly, so you stay informed. And while some advisors are happy to earn commissions whether you do well or not, Fisher Investments fees are structured so we do better when you do better. In other words, we're on your side. Maybe that's why most of our clients come from other money managers. So if you're in or nearing retirement, talk with us and find out why investors are switching to and staying with Fisher Investments. Fisher Investments, clearly better money management. Investments in securities involve the risk of loss. Visit us at fisherinvestments.com to find out what we can do for you.
Imagine a fall weekend where stories are told, tales that amuse the young and old, adventures and mysteries and laughter abound, and stories that spook you and legends are found. Escape to a place where words come to life, where smiles and fights are a storyteller's delight. Bring your folks to the courthouse square and spark their imagination with a story they'll share. The 13th Annual Athens Storytelling Festival, October 22nd through the 26th. For tickets and information, visit AthensStorytellingFestival.com.
Giving service with a smile. That's my reason for choosing Huntsville Hospital.
Crystal Ditto needed a recipe for relief. Back pain was making it impossible for her to serve up the friendly customer service that had become a hallmark at her restaurant. Thanks to back surgery and the expertise of neurosurgeons at Huntsville Hospital Spine and Neuro Center, she's back serving up her favorite meals, and she's doing it with a smile.
You can hear more about my story and my surgery at Huntsville Hospital by visiting myreason.org.
Sean Hannity.
We need sanity brought to Congress.
Weekday afternoons 2 to 5 on WBHP. Now on 102.5 FM.
.656 on the morning show. All right, Crazy Train coming back up. So it looks like there's a transcript of a phone call between Bill Clinton and Tony Blair from the UK, where Bill Clinton asked Tony Blair to do him a favor.
Oh.
Yeah.
Well, Bill Clinton's favors and Trump's favors are two different things, Ms. Lowry.
And, huh. Well, not that kind of a favor. I'm sorry.
How do you know?
I didn't. No, no. It was political season, so he was asking. Oh, okay. We'll have to get back to that.
Okay.
I'll have to look through that transcript in a minute.
No.
All right, the Crazy Train's up next. Don't forget to get your football picks in. You could win cash, $100 in cash every week from Kerry Rosenblum, Rosenblum Realty. $50 in cash for second place. And at the end of the season, a $1,400 gun safe from Haley's on Bob Wallace and more. We'll get back to it. Don't go away.
There are many things that set Cochran Michaels retirement specialists above the bar. They're fiduciaries, required to put your financial interests ahead of their own, which is not a requirement in this industry. Cochran Michaels has been helping people in Huntsville for over 14 years turn their dream retirement into reality. Visit HuntsvilleFinancial.com today and book your free one-hour consultation. That's HuntsvilleFinancial.com.
Securities offered through Cambridge Investment Research Incorporated, member FINRA SIPC. Advisory services offered through Cambridge Investment Research Advisors Incorporated. Cochran Michaels and Cambridge are not affiliated.
The FBI is expanding in Huntsville, and you could be just who we need. You don't have to be a special agent to work for the FBI. We're bringing thousands of jobs and are seeking candidates from a wide range of personal and professional backgrounds, like finance, STEM, administration, intelligence analysis, and more. The FBI needs brilliant minds in Huntsville. Learn more at FBIjobs.gov/Huntsville. That's FBIjobs.gov/Huntsville. The FBI is an equal opportunity employer.
For victims of drunk and drug driving, our grief is unique. But you are not alone. You always have a place at MAD. Call our 24-hour victim helpline at 877-MAD-HELP or visit MAD.org.
Talking with Russ and Andy of Last Resort Guns on County Line Road in Madison.
Membership has its perks, doesn't it?
If you take a membership in the range, your regular admission is free. So you can come in the range as often as you want. And then if you want to take part in any of the events, so training classes, there's a membership discount on all of those. And then, of course, if you remember, the members' night, which is once a month, and that's free. And we lay on snacks and drinks for the members that evening so they get a chance to come. They can chat with one another, try out whatever we've got lined up on the day.
Visit Last Resort Guns in Madison on County Line Road just south of Palmer Road. Or give them a call today, 256-774-5741. That's Last Resort Guns.
This is WBHP Huntsville, WHOS Decatur, and WDRM-FM HD2 Decatur, Athens, Huntsville. The WBHP Morning Show continues after this Tennessee Valley News Update.
Good morning. I'm Melissa Rialka in the WHNT News 19 newsroom. Pilots for Southwest Airlines are suing Boeing over the grounding of its 737 MAX. The union that represents nearly 10,000 pilots is demanding $100 million in lost income. Southwest has canceled more than 30,000 flights since the FAA grounded the 737 MAX fleet in March, following two deadly crashes overseas. Kroger and Walgreens are the latest retailers to announce they'll stop selling e-cigarettes. The product under increased scrutiny after being linked to more than a dozen deaths nationwide. Many retailers, including Walmart and Rite Aid, have already taken action following the CDC's warning to users to stop vaping. Well, expect slow going on Highway 31 in parts of Limestone County. Today, crews will be working on the southbound side of the causeway between the interchange with Alabama 20 and the Hudson Memorial Bridge. Tomorrow, they'll work on the northbound side. They'll be out from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. both days with the outside lanes closed. And those are some of the stories making headlines this Tuesday, October 8th.
Your shot at $1,000 now. Text the nationwide keyword OWL to 200-200. You'll get a confirmation text and info. Standard data and message rates apply in this nationwide contest. That's OWL to 200-200.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is sponsored by Bill Penny Toyota's service department.
There's a crash on 565, a wreck on 565 eastbound at Mooresville Road, causing delays coming out of Decatur this morning. Already heavy and slow traffic on Research Park Boulevard southbound from Highway 72 down to 565 on the parkway. No wrecks or stalls, but already crowded around Hazel Green and Meridianville this morning. From the Traffic Center, I'm Captain Carl.
Need convenient and reliable service? Bill Penny Toyota's got you covered late night, Monday through Thursday, 7 a.m. through 11 p.m. Plus, receive a Lyft credit and other discounts after 6 p.m. Ask for Bob. Visit BillPennyToyota.com. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
Talking with Russ and Andy of Last Resort Guns on County Line Road in Madison.
Membership has its perks, doesn't it?
If you take up membership in the range, your regular admission is free. So you can come in the range as often as you want. And then if you want to take part in any of the events, so training classes, there's a membership discount on all of those. And then, of course, if you remember the members' night, which is once a month, and that's free. And we lay on snacks and drinks for the members that evening so they get a chance to come. They can chat with one another, try out whatever we've got lined up on the day.
Visit Last Resort Guns in Madison on County Line Road just south of Palmer Road. Or give them a call today, 256-774-5741. That's Last Resort Guns.
Hi, I'm Kerry Rosenblum, and we at Rosenblum Realty would like to make this year a wonderful year for you and your family by helping you into a home of your own. Whatever your housing needs are, we can help you with that dream of home ownership and make it a reality for you. Call us at 256-539-9501 or visit us on the web at rosenblumrealty.com, and we'll put our years of experience to work for you.
Listen to WBHP on your Amazon Echo. Just say, Alexa, play WBHP on iHeartRadio.
All aboard!
On the crazy train today. Welcome back into the morning show at 7:03. So a guy stepped up to help students in his community. We've heard a lot about these stories here lately. Raised more than $7,500 to pay off school lunch debts for kids.
Wow.
He created a fundraiser on Facebook with the initial goal of collecting $1,000. This was at Amherst County High School in Virginia. He said he had read several stories of kids having to put hot lunches back because they didn't have enough money. And on their cafeteria accounts.
Mm-hmm.
So he launched a fundraising page to help wipe out part of the $4,000 in negative debts. His campaign took in just about $7,600. Now, there are a lot of kids. We had that one instance in Pennsylvania where the principal said nobody's allowed to pay off their debt. They have to pay off their own debt. Mm-hmm. Look, if people want to step up and pay off debt for kids having lunch, let them do that. That is not hurting you.
You know, the school board come back and said, to heck with you, Mr. Principal. We want that money.
We want the money, yes. Now, granted, people should pay their debts.
Oh, sure.
You know, but there are a lot of kids who can't afford hot lunches at school.
Yeah.
And they don't maybe qualify for the free lunches.
Mm-hmm.
So if somebody wants to pay for their lunches, let them do it. Quit being crazy about this. Good grief. Crazy.
I'm going off the rails on a crazy train.
I love kids who are detectives. You know, gives them something to do, try to figure out problems, you know, as long as they're not going to get hurt or anything,
mm-hmm.
right? So this group of junior detectives helped California police find a 97-year-old woman who went missing. The police department asked for the public's help in locating her. Police shared that she had dementia and is mostly nonverbal and has been known to hide or hunker down in a location, which, you know, when you have dementia, it's bad. So a 10-year-old said he and his two friends were playing when they heard police in a helicopter asking for help looking for the missing woman. And they grabbed another friend and hopped on their bikes and started searching the park, the neighborhood. Even one kid actually took a tumble on his bike going down a hill. But they kept looking, and they found the woman.
Wow.
For the police. How about that?
Good, should be an award.
Good job, guys. Good job. Not crazy.
I'm going off the rails on a crazy train.
So you're going through a drive-thru, you're starving, you want them to hurry up. That's usually when you get the long line.
Oh, yeah.
But what happens if the person at the drive-thru decides they're going to start up a conversation with the person in the car?
Oh, I hate that. I hate it.
So this chatty employee at Jack in the Box in Bellflower, California, frustrated hungry customers, his car's backed up while she was joking with a driver picking up an order. And there is video of this. You might try to find that, Corey. The restaurant employee can be seen hanging out the window, holding the hand of the driver. She laughs and chats with him. And one customer a few cars back yells, "Yo, what's going on with the food?
Get a room."
The drive-thru employee says, "If you're going to be rude, I'm not going to take your order. You can go ahead and
really?
Leave. I'm not going to leave. I'm not going to take your order."
Wow.
There's audio of this. As the whole, not on our prep, but somewhere. As the whole exchange unfolds, she continues to hold hands with the driver at the window, and the driver eventually drove off. Now, the owner of the Jack in the Box has apologized. I don't know what's happened to the employee, but you know what? People are there to get their food. Feed them. They're hungry. They don't like waiting. You know, you have to wait so long anyway these days.
Yeah, if you want to chit-chat,
you know,
get out of the car and go in.
And go in, yeah, and chat. There you go. Crazy.
I'm going off the rails on a crazy train.
So this teenager was arrested after taking his dad's police uniform and a stop sign and then used it to collect fines from drivers. Now, he was arrested after a man on a motorcycle refused to pay a fine and called other officers when he became suspicious. But so he takes his dad's uniform and then takes a stop sign, and he's stopping drivers and saying there are fines for something.
How old is this?
Doesn't
person?
Say, just says he's a teen.
Hmm.
But he had to go through a whole lot to do that.
But, well, yeah.
But yeah, he's in a whole lot of trouble. Kind of crazy. Crazy.
I'm going off the rails on a crazy train.
All right, so you don't have enough to watch on TV. Jeff Daniels won an Emmy last year for playing FBI counterterrorism chief John O'Neill. Hulu's got this new series. Now he's going to play FBI director James Comey in an adaptation of Comey's book, his memoir, A Higher Loyalty. They'll either have it on Showtime or CBS All Access. So if you want
wow.
more James Comey and you want to see it in that light,
no, thank you.
What a great person James Comey is, you can look at that. All right, so when you were a kid, did you have like a blankie or something that you carried around? Do you remember?
I don't remember ever having anything like that, but my little brother had a blanket.
Did he?
Mm-hmm.
So this girl, she says hers is called a Woobie, W-O-O-B-Y. What's yours called?
A Woobie?
Yeah. So She says that she travels. She still takes it with her.
Justin, my little brother, called his chalupa.
He did not. Stop with the chalupa already. So I'm just curious. What did you call yours? Did you have a blankie when you were little? Call us. I want to know what you called yours.
I had a binky.
Everybody had a binky.
You know what a binky is?
Yes. Everybody had a binky, I guess.
256-534-3521 and 309-2313.
And are you still carrying it?
No, I do not have my binky.
Not the binky, the blankie.
Don't have that either.
All right, signs of a hard winter. Will it be a hard winter? According to some, here are some signs. Thicker than normal corn husks. Well, I haven't been out to look at them, so. Woodpeckers sharing a tree.
They don't share normally?
Well, I mean, one on each side, right? early arrival of the snowy owl. I don't think we get those here. Do we have snowy owls here?
I've heard owls. I don't know whether it's a snowy owl
or
not.
Well, they have to be white, I imagine.
Yeah.
Thick hair on the nape of a cow's neck.
Nap.
Nap. Is that what that is?
That's the nap of your neck. Okay. Maybe it's nape. Spell it.
N-A-P-E, so I don't know.
I've always heard it nap. Called the nap of the neck.
And so have you looked at any cows lately?
No, no.
Early arrival.
Well, yeah, but they were dead.
Early in your plate.
And cooked.
Early arrival of crickets on the hearth. Spiders spinning larger than usual webs. Pigs gathering sticks.
Huh?
Yeah.
What, for a bonfire or what? Are they going to roast them? Pigs are roasting. Don, one of our callers, he called in yesterday or the day before and told us that the woolly worm is woolier than usual, and that means
a hard winter.
A hard winter in the South.
All right, so that's going to be interesting. All right, and finally, I have a question.
Right.
A brain teaser for you guys. You ready?
I can't answer it.
So you guys can call in and answer this question in our trivia. So I've got two games going. I'm going to throw in another one.
Right.
So a man makes a claim that he can predict the exact score of every football game before it begins. He's always right. How is that possible? How is that possible? Call us.
A man claims he can predict
the exact score of every football game before it begins. And he's always right. How is that possible? Call us. Phone numbers are...
Well, hell, I don't know. 256-534-3521 and 309-2313.
Crazy.
I'm going off the rails on a crazy train.
WBHP.
Snooze.
All money managers might seem the same, but while some give their clients cookie-cutter portfolios, Fisher Investments tailors portfolios to your goals and needs. Some only call when they have something to sell. Fisher calls regularly, so you stay informed. And while some advisors are happy to earn commissions whether you do well or not, Fisher Investments fees are structured so we do better when you do better. In other words, we're on your side. Maybe that's why most of our clients come from other money managers. So if you're in or nearing retirement, talk with us and find out why investors are switching to and staying with Fisher Investments. Fisher Investments, clearly better money management. Investments in securities involve the risk of loss. Visit us at fisherinvestments.com to find out what we can do for you.
Say good morning to Mike Holt, Holt Siding and Replacement Windows. Mike, tell us what you do.
We install vinyl siding, energy-efficient replacement windows, gutters, shutters, just anything really good to do with exterior upgrades to your home.
And, Mike, it's important that people know they can depend on you.
You know, when we do a job for a customer and we put a sign in the yard, you know, that's my name on that sign. I'm as proud as I was in the first 24-foot walkboard I put on a truck and thought, boy, I'm downtown now because I've got a walkboard. You know, I started this from scratch, from nothing. So when we put a sign in your yard and we tell you we're going to do something, we take a lot of pride in that. And we take a lot of pride in checking up with our customers on down the road, call them up, and just a phone call. How's the windows doing? How's things going?
And experience matters.
Now, I've got guys that work for me that have a lot of experience. I tell our customers, we don't come to your house to gain experience, we bring it with us.
Call for your free estimate today. Holtz Siding and Replacement Windows, 256-288-0050.
Sean Hannity.
You remember in history, people had fire hoses shot at them. John Lewis had a brick thrown in his head. These protests that took place for civil rights, these were people led by Martin Luther King Jr. that put their lives on the line and faced anger and hostility. Yeah, they actually took to the streets. And they made this a more perfect union. They deserve all the credit for that.
Sean Hannity, weekday afternoons 2 to 5 on WBHP. Now on 102.5 FM. The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is sponsored by Bill Penny Toyota's service department.
There's a crash on 565, a wreck on 565 eastbound at Mooresville Road, causing delays coming out of Decatur this morning. Already heavy and slow traffic on Research Park Boulevard southbound from Highway 72 down to 565 on the parkway. No wrecks or stalls, but already crowded around Hazel Green and Meridianville this morning. From the Traffic Center, I'm Captain Carl.
Need convenient and reliable service? Bill Penny Toyota's got you covered late night, Monday through Thursday, 7 a.m. through 11 p.m. Plus, receive a lift credit and other discounts after 6 p.m. Ask for Bob. Visit BillPennyToyota.com. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
Express your opinion. Let your voice be heard. Call the WBHP Morning Show now at 256-534-3521 or 309-2313.
Say good morning to Roger House, APS, Alabama Professional Services. Roger, what are the clues that you can see in your house? There might be something wrong with their foundation.
Cracks in the concrete. I was up here the other day. I had one where the inside of the garage has fallen, and it had a 3-inch gap in it from the wall. So we had to jack it back up. But you have to look at that. I mean, uneven concrete, cracking wall, bricks cracked, freeze board, the very top board on your house has moved out about 3 inches or something like that because the house has fallen.
And how do you fix that?
We have products, push piers, helical piers, where we can jack the house back up. We go in, we put these in the ground, we put brackets on the main foundation, and we drive it to load-bearing strata and pick up on the house.
If you leave it and let it go, then you could have major problems, couldn't you?
It could get very expensive if you leave it alone. I mean, very expensive. Yeah. You could look at a side of a house falling off, brick falling off. If you ever go to sell your house, nobody will buy it because of the foundation issues.
Call APS Foundation Services today, 256-417-4293. Or go to AlabamaProfessionalServices.com and ask Roger.
From the Yellowhammer Roofing Weather Center.
Now, your official WBHP Weather Center forecast.
This report is sponsored by Mattress Firm.
I'm WHNT News 19 meteorologist Ben Smith. Scattered cloud cover around through the afternoon. Could be a couple of isolated showers. Otherwise, a cool afternoon with highs in the upper 70s. Partly cloudy tonight, down into the upper 50s. And for tomorrow, a warmer afternoon. Only an isolated shower for Wednesday with highs in the mid-80s. Take my forecast and WBHP with you everywhere. Download the iHeartRadio app at WBHP1025.com.
At Mattress Firm, for a limited time, take home a free adjustable base with purchase of $699. Plus, get up to $400 in savings and enjoy 0% APR for 6 years. Zero down and zero due at signing. Shop the Save Big Sale online or in store.
It's happening. Wherever cupcakes are being frosted, songs are being recorded, and engines are being tuned, ADP is designing a better way to work. With industry-leading HR, talent, time, benefits, and payroll, more companies rely on ADP than any other HR partner. From small business to global enterprise, see how ADP can help you and your people achieve what you're working for at design.adp.com. ADP, always designing for people. ADP isn't just in the payroll business. We're in the people business, helping companies find them, train them, and empower them by clearing the way for them to do their best work. Because when your people thrive, your business thrives with them. HR, talent, time, benefits, and payroll. Informed by data and designed for people, so you and your company can achieve what you're working for. Learn more at design.adp.com.
Sean Hannity.
I don't care what liberals say. I'm all for free speech.
Weekday afternoons, 2 to 5 on WBHP. Now on 102.5 FM.
Hi, this is Russ Sterling for Last Resort Guns. Coming up on the 19th of October, we have an all-day Steyr sale. We'll be test-firing Steyr pistols and Steyr rifles on the range, all Steyr pistols and rifles on sale, supported by the Steyr staff from the Steyr factory down in Birmingham, Alabama.
That would be Last Resort Guns, County Line Road in Madison. Just another clarification, if you miss the 5 o'clock hour, then you can listen to our podcast after the show. So it looks like there's been a clarification about the troops that are moving out of Syria.
Oh, yeah?
They're not moving out of Syria.
They're moving from that area, but still in Syria?
Yes.
Is that what you're going to tell
me?
Yes.
So they're talking about a small number of troops, and I understand they're mostly advisors, that are going to move to other bases within Syria.
Okay.
Not just in that area that Turkey wants back.
Well, mainstream media probably won't say that.
No. But there was a briefing in the foreign policy establishment, it looks like, after they've denounced all of this. Mm-hmm. If they're only moving to other bases inside Syria, then that means the Kurds. And remember, and like I say, you need to listen to the 5 o'clock hour because there are different Kurds. There are good Kurds and bad Kurds. The PKK are terrorists. They're Kurds, too.
Yeah.
They're Marxist, anarchist-type people. Mm-hmm. And so if they're moving the good Kurds with them, that's one thing. And then you have 70,000. So the good Kurds were watching the camps that have about 12,000 ISIS fighters and about 70,000 wives and children. And that's what Trump has been railing on, that the countries they belong to, they need to take them back and they won't. And we can't keep paying the Kurds to watch them.
Right.
So something has to be done with them. If Turkey takes them, they're just going to let them go, I imagine.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Yeah. But anyway, so it looks like they're just moving them to other bases at this point. But what are they taking the Kurds with them? And what are they going to do? What are they going to do with those 70,000 women and children, families of the ISIS fighters and the 12,000 ISIS fighters that are in another camp that the Kurds are watching? What's going to happen to them? That's going to be, and remember, this is just.
Well, that's not a troop. If that's true, that's not a troop withdrawal. That's
a troop moving.
Yeah, they're shuffling stuff around.
Yeah, they're shuffling it around so they don't get caught up. It looks like Syria may have already dropped some bombs on that area. I mean, Turkey. Mm. So if they're wanting that particular land there in northern Syria, which they say is part of Turkey, they want a buffer there to keep the PKK and others out, then we may have moved the troops so that they don't get caught up in that.
Mm.
I don't know. We don't know the whole story yet.
No.
Anyway, all right, let's go to...
May not ever know the whole story.
Hey, Joe, how are you?
Doing pretty good. I told Corey I could predict the score of a game before it begins. And before a game begins, the score is 0-0.
That's what it is. 0-0.
Really?
But don't let anybody take your money on that one.
Oh, man makes a claim that he can predict the exact score of every football game before it begins. He's always right. How's that possible? Because it's always 0-0. Very good, Joe.
See y'all.
So that's a riddle of sorts.
It's a trick question.
There's a one that's going around the internet now that I can't figure out the answer to. Maybe one of you guys can. Can I give it, Ms. Lane?
Go ahead.
Can I give some trivia?
You can. Kind of?
Someone's mother has four sons.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I just figured it out. Anyway, someone's mother has four sons, north, west, and south. What is the name of the fourth son?
Say that again now.
Someone's mother has four sons, north, west, and south. What is the name of the fourth son?
All right. Phone numbers are
256-534-3521 and 309-2313. By the way, I can't tell you if you're right or not, because I don't know the answer.
Well, if you don't know the answer, well, you can't give out trivia, because you don't know if they're right.
What's a riddle?
No, but you have to have the answer.
Well, I'll Google it and see if I can find the answer.
Because how do you know if they're right? Good grief. Let's go to Brian. Hey, Brian, number one. How are you?
Oh, it's
All right. Yeah. Y'all sound like you're having fun. I'm going to say the answer for the fourth son is Clint, as in Eastwood.
That's good.
That's good. But since he doesn't know the correct answer.
That may be right. We don't know.
Don't get trivia if you don't know the answer.
Oh, boy. Speaking of your trivia, the top things people are afraid of, how about your residence being a mobile home during tornado season? Is that on the list?
Tornadoes and hurricanes are on the list, but not the mobile home part.
Oh, okay.
It is. Number 8 on the list.
And I look forward to listening to that transcript of Clint Eastwood asking Tony Blair for his favors. He's more twisted than I thought.
Clint Eastwood?
Bill Clinton.
Bill Clinton, yes. You're still
Bill Clinton asking. Okay.
Yes.
My head is in the clouds.
It's okay. Yeah, you're an IT guy. You're always in the cloud, right?
Ouch. Good one. See you.
Thank you, Brian. And Brian number 2. Hey, Brian.
Hey, good morning. I was the last caller yesterday morning.
Yeah,
and
you can't call right before we
I know it. That's okay. That's part of the thing of talk radio. You just have to roll the dice on. But anyway, when I called in, the people on 800 AM did not hear what I said because 800 AM was off the air, and I want to quickly repeat what I said. There was an article in the Decatur Communist Daily recently. It says, ex-state senator convicted of felony theft, and I immediately knew how the news media works. I said, well, he must be a Democrat because the article does not say he's a Democrat. And if he'd been a Republican, the article would have read, ex-Republican state senator convicted of felony theft. Yeah. And I was right. It was Zeb Little. He's was an attorney in Cullman. And the Attorney General's office presented the evidence. He was convicted of stealing money from a deceased person's estate. Now, that's sorry. And he's going to have to pay back about $74,000. And don't know if he's going to serve jail time or not. You know, the Democrats usually don't serve jail time, or if they do, it's minimum. So I'll try to keep a watch on that and see what his actual sentence will be. But I just wanted to repeat that since 800 a.m. people didn't hear that yesterday morning.
Well, I didn't know we were off.
We were off
when we came in.
I have two AM radios, and I had both of them on to make sure that it wasn't a problem on my end.
That's all right. And
I left the AM radio on 800 to see when you came back on the air, and I looked at my watch. Y'all came back on the air at exactly 8:21 yesterday morning on AM 800.
Hmm. I guess the engineer fixed it.
Yeah. But, okay, well, thank you. I just wanted to tell you about the old Zeb Little stealing from dead people.
Yeah, keep us up to date on that, okay?
Okay, thank you.
And Charlotte. Hey, Charlotte.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
I just want to get qualified, please.
You are in there, Charlotte.
Thank you.
All right, dear. And Thomas. Hey, Thomas.
Oh, hey, you got to me quicker than I thought. I'll just get in there then.
Hated to keep you hanging. You just want to qualify?
Oh, yeah, no problem. Yep.
You're in there. Thank you, Thomas. All right. So let's get Lindsey Graham in here. He was on with Maria Bartiromo, and she asked him some very interesting questions about this whistleblower and whether or not he's going to testify.
Mm-hmm.
And will Lindsey Graham start sending out subpoenas?
Because he ain't doing nothing right
now. He's doing nothing right now. And you can't wait on the Inspector General report on FISA abuse, which is what he said in one of these, but because that has nothing to do with this. You need to get on this quickly, like Democrats are getting on it quickly.
Yep.
All right, go ahead.
You have subpoena power, Chairman of Judiciary. Are you going to subpoena this whistleblower?
Well, here's what's going to happen. If the whistleblower's allegations are turned into an impeachment article, it's imperative that the whistleblower be interviewed in public, under oath, and cross-examined. Nobody in America goes to jail or has anything done to them without confronting their accuser. So here's what I'm going to insist upon, that the whistleblower, one or two, whatever, they come forward under oath, testify so the public can judge her credibility. If that doesn't happen in the House, I will make sure it happens in the Senate.
Okay, because that's one other thing being criticized about this whole process. They are doing this behind closed doors. We're going to speak with John Ratcliffe in a minute, and he was in the room when Kurt Volker testified. But the American people don't know what happened, even though there's a lot of commentary about it, how he completely shot down any issues that the president did something wrong in that meeting on Friday. So you will put a spotlight on it. If you see that it is only being done behind closed doors, you will subpoena the whistleblower then.
Yeah, I will use Nancy Pelosi's words. This is about the Constitution and democracy. The Sixth Amendment allows people to confront witnesses against them. There can be no valid inquiry unless Democrats vote. Mm-hmm. And once you vote, there can be no valid impeachment process unless the president can confront the witnesses against him.
Okay.
Who are these people? Where do they come from? Are they tied to Brennan at all? These are questions I'd like to know.
Mm-hmm. All right, then. So
we're going to have to wait and see how the House acts before Lindsey Graham does anything?
Looks that way. And again, this is drip, drip, drip. So they're trying to make this last as long as possible without any facts.
Yeah.
Just go ahead and subpoena him so we can get to it.
Yeah.
Let's find out what's going on. Let's do it so that we can either go forward or put this to rest one way or the other, right?
Yeah, I agree.
All right. So this China thing has kind of taken a little, the NBA in China.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it looks
That's
like
a little weird.
What happened is the Rockets general manager, Daryl Morey, sent out a tweet saying, "We stand with Hong Kong." Now, they have been playing in China, and the NBA can now broadcast their NBA games in China. There's an NBA exhibition game in China this week. But since he sent that out, the Chinese have come completely unglued. All these protests in Hong Kong. And Beijing is ticked off about it. So the Chinese foreign minister criticized Morley's comment and said, quote, "I suggest they pay attention to the reaction of the ordinary Chinese people, blah, 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 blah." Well, looks like they're going to ban the NBA. So he didn't apologize, the general manager, Daryl Morey. He didn't apologize. Well, he apologized but for any hurt feelings, but he didn't apologize. So the NBA came out and apologized. Because guess what? That's a lot of money. Yeah. They're making a ton of money on the NBA games being played there. And now it looks like they're not going to air them. Okay, so what's wrong with you people? Why would you apologize for saying we stand with Hong Kong after what you're doing to Hong Kong?
Yep.
You know, you're not abiding by the rules. Now, I know that they had a 100-year lease, but then the lease was going to be up, and you were going to abide by certain rules that they could still, you know, have their democracy there and everything they want in Hong Kong. And you decide you're going to take it over.
Right.
Mm. Anyway, reports have said this is worth about $1.58 billion to the NBA.
Ooh.
So it's about the money. It's all it's about. It's about the money. We'll see where that goes. A lot of people on both sides of the aisle, by the way, are.
So one of the problems we have in this day and age is everybody wants to apologize for something that they say that they truly believe in.
Yes.
Demi Lovato. Perfect example.
Who is that?
She's a pop singer.
Okay.
She went to Israel last week.
Oh, yeah.
And she was baptized, and she said, she posted on Instagram, she said, "I'm feeling a God-sized hole in my heart." Well, about 24 hours later, she ended up coming out and apologizing for saying that, because she says, "I apologize if I hurt or offended anybody." Well, screw anybody. This is the relationship between you and God. Screw anybody who is hurt or offended by it. They can go jump off a cliff somewhere. But she did. She came out and apologized. But now her mother come out and said, "Well, I'm not apologizing for anything." And then, have you seen that the mayor of Minneapolis is doing what he can to keep Donald Trump out of there?
Yeah, this is an interesting turn of events because, so they're trying to basically extort the Trump administration. So the mayor of Minneapolis hates Trump, and the arena where he's having
his rally coming up October 10th, mm-hmm. that's called the Target Center.
Right. So normally the Secret Service and the mayor or the mayor's committee, they decide or they come up with what it's going to cost for security, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so this mayor is wanting to charge them like four times what he charged Obama for having a rally, a healthcare rally in the same place.
26 times.
26 times? Okay.
They want to charge $530,000 for security, which is more than 26 times the estimated security cost of the 2009 rally held by Barack Obama, which was $20,000.
Okay, so 500 and how much thousand?
530,000.
Yeah. So he wants to charge 530,000 for security? And he only charged $20,000 for security for Barack Obama.
Well, what he's trying to do is keep Trump
out
from coming.
Yes.
Because he hates Trump.
Yes.
Jacob Fry is the name of the mayor there.
So I wonder what they're going to do. Because the arena...
They're going to take him to court.
Well, the arena is in the middle of this, right?
Yes. Because what the mayor is really trying to do is charge the arena in hopes that the arena tells... Mm-hmm. tells Donald Trump to go jump off a cliff somewhere.
Well, it looks like it looks like the Target Center's management tried to pass it on to the Trump campaign.
They did.
Threatening to block them from using the arena if they didn't pay.
Yep. But there will be a lawsuit filed if that happens.
Before Thursday?
Let's see. Where did I read that? Really? This last minute squeeze. Nothing but political. Yep. Oh, yeah. I did that too. Where did I read that he was going to sue the heck out of them?
Well, again, that would be a breach.
Because it's a breach of contract.
It would be a breach. Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It'd be a breach of contract. So we'll see where that all flies. And then a judge ruled that the DA in Manhattan could have 8 years of Trump's tax returns.
Yeah.
Now, why does a DA, because what they say they're looking into is the payoffs to Stormy Daniels and the other girl. Well, that happened in 2016. So why do they need 8 years of tax returns?
Yeah, I don't know.
You know, so
they're fishing.
So they went directly to the Second Circuit, I think it was, and got a stay because they don't need 8 years of tax returns to find out about that.
Right.
Anyway, so that'll be held up in court for a while. But let's see, how many people want his tax returns now? New York State, New York City, Manhattan, California.
A bunch of Democrats.
California got shot down by the Supreme Court, saying that the California Supreme Court, because they wanted it to be that you couldn't be on the ballot unless you released your tax returns. Well, you can't add things to the constitutional requirements to be president. So they shot that one down. But again, if you want to find out how much he paid or what the situation was, if he paid women off, you don't need 8 years of tax returns for that.
No.
Let's see. How many ways can you harass the president?
Well, they've found a bunch of them.
Yeah. I have a list of some accomplishments from the president.
Yeah.
Which they need to put out there.
We never get to hear that list much.
Don't get to hear that. All right. We'll be back. Don't go away.
Listen to Tony and Gary on your smartphone.
Download the free iHeartRadio app and listen anywhere in the U.S.
And we're on HD Radio 102.1-2.
Listen to WBHP on your Amazon Echo. Just say, Alexa, play WBHP on iHeartRadio.
And don't forget to like our Facebook page, facebook.com/Tony and Gary.
It's the morning show with Tony and Gary on 800 and 1230 WBHP.
And now on 102.5 FM.
There are many things that set Cochran Michaels Retirement Specialists above the bar. Laura Michaels at Cochran Michaels is a designated Retirement Income Certified Professional, or RICP, and only 7.5% of U.S. financial advisors carry this designation. With over 40 years of experience, Cochran Michaels Retirement Specialists. Visit HuntsvilleFinancial.com today and book your free one-hour consultation. That's HuntsvilleFinancial.com.
Securities offered through Cambridge Investment Research Incorporated, member FINRA SIPC. Advisory services offered through Cambridge Investment Research Advisors Incorporated. Cochran Michaels and Cambridge are not affiliated.
Getting back on my horse. That's my reason for choosing Huntsville Hospital.
Vague symptoms had been bothering horse enthusiast and retired nurse Joy Tornquist. Even with her nursing knowledge, she never imagined her symptoms would lead to triple bypass surgery. But she did know that she was in good hands with her Heart Center cardiac surgeon. Now, she's back in the saddle again.
You can hear more about how bypass surgery saved my life by visiting myreason.org.
Want to qualify for today's huge prize package? Call the WBHP Morning Show now at 256-534-3521 or 309-2313.
During a medical emergency, every minute matters. That's why at Crestwood Medical Center, you'll find less waiting where you need it most, in our emergency room. In fact, we will work to have you initially seen by a medical professional with the shortest wait time possible. And because we're a full-service hospital, we can provide more care if you need it. If you experience a medical emergency, count on the ER at Crestwood Medical Center for great care with less waiting.
Americans are always on the move. They're in the car, at the office, working around the house. Americans refuse to sit still. So how do you connect with all of these moving targets? Easy, with radio. Radio reaches 93% of Americans every week, more than Google, Facebook, even television. Because hey, who has the time to sit and watch TV? So when you want to connect with all those constantly moving adults, teens, and millennials, get to iHeartMedia.com and put AM/FM radio to work for your company.
The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is sponsored by Bill Penny Toyota's service department.
Two problems on the interstate this morning around the Decatur area. Traffic is backed up because of a crash on 565 eastbound at Mooresville Road. And there's a crash 65 southbound between 565 and the Tennessee River Bridge. No problems if you're heading up and down the Parkway or Research Park Boulevard. No problems on 431 around Big Cove. From the Traffic Center, I'm Captain Carl.
Need convenient and reliable service? Bill Penny Toyota's got you covered late night, Monday through Thursday, 7 a.m. through 11 p.m. Plus, receive a Lyft credit and other discounts after 6 p.m. Ask for Bob. Visit BillPennyToyota.com. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
WBHP is available everywhere you want to listen on our free iHeartRadio app. Download it now.
Welcome back to the morning show. Okay, what are we giving away?
$40 for Popeye's Cajun Fried Chicken. Movie passes for two at Hollywood 18. $20 from Dunkin' Donuts, Huntsville and Madison.
All you have to do is call us. At the end of the show, we'll draw from all the people who have called in, and that person wins.
534-3521 and 309-2313.
And we've added prices. Rooster's Men's Grooming Center, the Club Cut, the Hot Shave, the Neck Massage. All right, so we still have our Family Feud out there. We've gotten about five answers. We still have others. What, according to a new survey, there are 10 things. These are the top 10 things that Americans fear the most. What do you think's on the list? We already have snakes and crowds and clowns, things along those lines, tornadoes and hurricanes and fire. But a couple of these are a little odd. So what do you think is on the list? Call us. Phone numbers are
256-534-3521 and 309-2313.
All right, let's go to the phone and so, talk. Huh? Go ahead.
There's a package that's it says there are unconfirmed reports of a suspicious package outside the Supreme Court building in D.C. It says unconfirmed reports, but I'm looking at live video, and every emergency vehicle they have in the city is there, including the bomb squad. But that's all the information I have, other than idiots commenting.
Oh,
really? Yeah. Doesn't surprise me after asking for the records yesterday with Trump. Now this, impeach him now.
Impeach him now. Yeah.
So
go ahead, vote.
So Trump is blowing up the Supreme Court.
Yeah. Go ahead, vote, Nancy Pelosi. By the way, there is another alert that says that the ambassador that was supposed to appear at the to be deposed in the House behind closed doors.
Yep.
Trump says has ordered the U.S. ambassador to the European Union not to appear.
Oh.
Do not appear. Remember what he said?
Obstruction.
Well, yeah, that's what they remember. We told you yesterday. That's so they're going to use all of these things to say that the president needs to be impeached because of obstruction of justice. But remember what he said. If you want to subpoena people and you want us to cooperate, then hold a vote and a real formal impeachment inquiry.
Let's get on with it.
But nope. Nancy Pelosi said she doesn't have to. And so I guess she doesn't have to.
Well, no. And she does not have to. In the Constitution, she does not have to hold a vote. But that's the way it's always been done.
Right. Nixon and Clinton, they held the vote. Then they had the hearings. Then they had another vote to see if they wanted to impeach. Right.
Tony, what could go wrong with this? There is now the first electric cruise ship. Holds 530 passengers.
Isn't that water?
Yeah.
Electricity? Well, I don't know if that, I don't know how that would work.
I don't know, but with all the trouble we have with cruise ships today, I ain't getting on an electric one.
How far can they go?
Or at least not the first
one. So we had the girl that you know, tried to come across the ocean from the UK, right?
Yeah, an electric something.
In an electric sailboat or something like that. And so I guess it can be done, but don't you have to have other ships involved in order to help you do that? You can't just do it on one charge, right?
I don't know. Maybe somebody can call us. Maybe there's some hydroelectricity involved since they are in the ocean.
Oh, okay.
But I'm just saying I wouldn't be one of the first 530 passengers. That thing's going to have to make several voyages.
Does it sound like the Titanic?
At the moment.
The maiden voyage?
530 people.
I wonder what they paid for that to be the first ones. I wonder if they're all environmentalists or
I don't know.
Activists, things along those lines.
I just thought that an electric cruise ship. I don't think so.
All right, let's go to the phone and talk to Donald. Hey, Donald, how are you? Donald.
Woo-hoo. Good morning.
Hey.
How are y'all doing this morning?
Good.
All right, just called in to qualify.
You are in there. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. And Carlos. Hey, Carlos.
Good morning, Tony. Good morning, Tony.
Hey.
Hey, when's all them deadbeat Republicans going to get off their rump and start fighting back on these bunch of snakes?
Got me. I have no idea.
This is ridiculous. And if everybody, I blame them just as much as damn stupid Democrats, because they're guilty too, because they won't fight back and stand up for this president that's doing the best it's ever been for this country. But anyway, y'all have a good day. Just keep on punching at them. See ya.
All right. I can hear you, Corey, just in case you need to know that. Thank you, Carlos. All right. So I wanted to go over a little bit of this list because this never is talked about. I just want to let you know we could hear you. That's all.
Huh?
I was trying to let you know we could hear you talking.
Oh. Well, that's okay. I didn't say anything bad.
Good. that's a good thing. Let's go to Will. Hey, Will, how are you?
I'm great. How y'all doing this morning?
Good. What do you do, Will?
I'm an electrical engineer that works on Redstone and Arsenal for the Missile Defense Agency.
Very good. All right, you got an answer to our question?
Yeah, so basically all the drives on cruise ships are electric anyway. They burn oil to run generators, and the generators provide the direct electric drive for the actual drive propulsion for the cruise ship. So all you're doing is going from using something to, you know, burn oil or something to a huge battery capacity on the cruise ship to charge up before you leave.
So, how long would that battery last? Or would it recharge?
Well, think about how big a cruise ship is. So you could have a huge amount of batteries on a cruise ship. So
if one went down, it's no big deal. Right? If one or two went down, it wouldn't be that big of a deal.
Well, no, because you'd have some, you can series batteries into multiple ways so that you have, you know, capacity for it. So if you lose a load bank, you don't lose the entire battery capacity for the entire cruise ship. You'd have to lose all the batteries, but you'd lose speed.
Well, okay, that's what I was going to ask you. Does it go slower?
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay. So it would take a lot longer to get where you're going.
Yeah, and if you're trying to, like, if you're trying to be conservative, say a lot of times you cruise at a specific speed, there's probably a speed that is the most efficient on your batteries that somebody's probably figured out.
So you would probably have to prepare, I mean, you'd have to prepare the people on board that they were going to be on the water a lot longer than they had anticipated.
Yeah, or you do shorter routes, like 3-day cruises with this type of boat.
Okay.
Instead of a 7-day cruise, it's just a 3-day cruise ship.
That makes sense. Well, have you ever been on a cruise?
If all of those batteries die, you just have to say sink or swim.
Well, they have paddles.
You're in a pretty bad shape if all the batteries die on a ship like that because you got no power for anything.
Yeah.
Oh, that would be a mess.
And see, that's what I'm scared of. Put that on the list. Cruise ships.
Have you been?
Well, thank y'all.
Have you ever been on a cruise, Will?
Oh yeah, I've been on several cruises.
Yeah, where'd you go?
I've been to the Bahamas. I've been to Hawaii, and I've been to Alaska.
You cruise to Hawaii?
Yeah, it's a great cruise.
How long did that take?
It's like a 3-day out, and then you cruise in between the islands, and then you fly back.
Oh, that's
okay.
Cool.
I'm sorry. I was thinking you were cruising out of L.A. to Hawaii or wherever. It's like,
no, no, that's right. You cruise out of L.A. over to Hawaii, and then you cruise between all the islands, and then you fly back.
Oh, then you fly back.
Out of Honolulu.
Okay.
Yeah,
so,
you fly back.
So it only takes, how long does it take to get from the mainland to Hawaii on a cruise ship?
It's about 3 days.
3 days. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Yeah, because that's a long flight.
Oh, it is. It's a long flight, but, you know, they treat you well when you're on a cruise.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Well, they feed you, that's true. And
oh,
other.
Yeah,
and
do.
Other. Thank
well,
you, Will.
I appreciate y'all. I always love y'all's show.
Oh, thank you so much for calling in. We appreciate it.
Y'all have a great night.
You know, I have said this many, many, many times. All we have to do is throw out a question, and we will get an answer. You guys are so smart.
Will didn't seem to think it was really that big of a deal for an electric cruise ship.
Yeah. So, especially on a shorter, I can see that on a 3-day, and so because you're going to go a lot slower. You know, I know people like to be on the cruise ship, but you know, you want to get to your port of call too, wherever you're going to get off and do things.
Yeah, go shopping and whatever else you do.
See, my big fear because it happened. You know, I went deep sea fishing in the Gulf of Mexico.
You did?
Yeah, and so
why?
Why?
Why would you do something like
that? Well, everybody was going, so I didn't want to be the only one.
I see. You were going along to get along.
I was going along to get along. Anyway, and so the beginning, it wasn't so bad. You know, waters were calm and everything. But then a water spout came. A storm came up, as they do in the Gulf.
Mm-hmm.
Water spout is not too far from us.
Ooh.
And we are just flipping all over the place, right?
Mm-hmm.
The waves. Well, I then get seasick.
Well, yeah.
So I go down into the cabin. Down, you know, everybody's up there, but I go down in where...
They're all having a great time.
Yeah, where I...
You feel like you're on your last leg.
To get sick.
Yeah.
And I think the captain gave me something for it.
Yeah, probably something for your...
Yeah, so whatever it was that he gave me knocked me out.
Of course it did.
And so the next thing I knew, my friends were
trying to wake you up.
Wake up. We're back.
Yeah, we're back.
I missed the whole trip, the whole thing.
But you were very well rested.
I was a little groggy. but I do have to say that before all that happened, they did let me hold on to some of their trying to catch big fish.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do it by yourself.
Oh, no.
No. So they were helping me, and I never did see a fish the whole trip. So,
if only in your dreams.
In my dreams. That's my luck. I go deep sea fishing and end up sleeping
and
the whole
sleep.
Trip. All right. But I was ready. I was ready to go out, and everybody else was exhausted. So we'll take a break. Don't go away.
WBHP. From the Tennessee Valley to your radio, it's WBHP's Valley Happenings.
CASA of Madison County's fourth annual Clays for CASA fundraiser will take place on Friday, October 11th at Limestone Hunting Preserve and Sporting Clays. Clays for CASA is a great day for team building and networking, all while benefiting our aging and homebound in Madison County. We invite you to join our 2019 High Flyer sponsors, Oasis Inc. and Windsor Windows and Doors, for this fun day for all skill levels. Paid registrations by August 31st will receive free 12-gauge ammunition thanks to our ammunition sponsor, Cochran Michaels Retirement Specialist. Sponsors and teams can register at claysforcasa.com.
And that's what's happening. For more information on Valley Happenings, log on to WBHPAM.com, keyword events. The traffic info you need now. Here's a WBHP Time Saver traffic update.
This report is sponsored by Bill Penny Toyota's service department.
Two big problems around the Decatur area, both of those on the interstate. First of all, a crash 65 southbound past 565 is causing delays in both directions. Also, a crash 565 eastbound Mooresville Road, backing up traffic beyond the interstate onto Highway 20 as you're trying to leave Decatur, getting on the interstate. So, well, once again, two big problems there. Wreck 65 southbound past 565 causing delays, and a wreck 565 eastbound at Mooresville Road causing a backup there. From the Traffic Center, I'm Captain Carl.
Need convenient and reliable service? Bill Penny Toyota's got you covered late night, Monday through Thursday, 7 a.m. through 11 p.m. Plus, receive a Lyft credit and other discounts after 6 p.m. Ask for Bob. Visit BillPennyToyota.com. Terms and conditions apply. See dealer for details.
Now you can listen to the Glenn Beck program on your Amazon Echo device. Just say, Alexa, play WBHP on iHeartRadio.
Welcome back into the morning show. Ms. Lowry's straggling out there. Let's get to the phone and talk to Thomas. Hey, Thomas.
Hey, I called in earlier and didn't have anything to say, but I was going to respond to your cruise ship question. Just add to what Will had said. It is it's a hybrid system, so it uses normal, you know, like diesel engines to power generators that charge batteries that then run the electric motors. And I think this particular cruise ship, if it's the same one that I read about that sails out of Norway,
yep,
it only has about an hour maybe of battery capacity.
Uh-oh.
So it really operates primarily just on normal, you know, petroleum products, but it enables the engines to operate at their maximum efficiency all the time, and right, any excess power that's produced charges the batteries.
So it's kind of like the Chevy Cruze. You use battery as long as it lasts, then you go to fuel.
Up against a hard break here.
We are a Ring distributor.
We're talking with Ed Jaco at Inline Lighting.
You've probably seen on the internet people who have proof that their packages were stolen, or you can see when somebody comes up to your home. There's really just lots of benefits to that technology. It's always beneficial to be able to look at who's at your front door. They don't know if you're at home. You're talking to them. You could be in China or somewhere and talking to them. The smart home technology is just great for security as well as convenience. Come visit our beautiful showroom at 2880 Bob Wallace Avenue in Huntsville. We're always open at Inline. Lighting.com.
The FBI is expanding in Huntsville, and you could be just who we need. You don't have to be a special agent to work for the FBI. We're bringing thousands of jobs and are seeking candidates from a wide range of personal and professional backgrounds, like finance, STEM, administration, intelligence analysis, and more. The FBI needs brilliant minds in Huntsville. Learn more at FBIjobs.gov/Huntsville. That's FBIjobs.gov/Huntsville. The FBI is an equal opportunity employer.
ADP isn't just in the payroll business. We're in the people business, helping companies find them, train them, and empower them by clearing the way for them to do their best work. Because when your people thrive, your business thrives with them. HR, talent, time, benefits, and payroll. Informed by data and designed for people, so you and your company can achieve what you're working for. Learn more at design.adp.com.
Lowe's has the supplies pros use most every day. And when the job demands more, we're stocked with the quantities needed for any size job. It's savings you can count on. Because when you buy in bulk, you'll get 10% off all drywall and drywall accessories. Purchase 64 or more sheets of OSB and you'll also save 10%. Order ahead at lowesforpros.com and we'll have your order ready for pickup. Our pro loaders will be ready to load you up so you can get back to the job site. Do it right for less. Start with Lowe's. U.S. only.
This is WBHP, the Valley's Big Talker.
Now on 102.1 HD2.
All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
Here we go. Congratulations to David Lowry. No relation. Let me just say that. No relation. I didn't give, it's not nepotism. I didn't give somebody a prize.
Nepotism.
Anyway.
That's great.
All right. Weather? It's cool. Feels good out there.
Feels good outside. It is.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Okay, so we're looking for mostly sunny skies today. 76 is trying to update my temperature.
It's 61.
61. That's exactly what it is. And we're looking for 76. No rain until Friday night. Just in time for Friday night football.
57 tonight.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to need a sweater. Boy, you go from hundreds to need a sweater.
I'm too fat for a sweater at 57. Better be 37.
Thank you guys so much for listening. Join us early, 5 a.m.
Glenn Beck follows Fox News on WBHP Huntsville, WHOS Decatur, and WTRM FM HD2 Decatur, an iHeart radio station.
Fox News, I'm Chris Foster. A lawyer for the European Union Ambassador Gordon Sondland says the State Department has told him to now not testify today with staff for three House committees.
Sondland is one of the diplomats who exchanged text messages discussing Ukrainian aid that was held up and later released. This is House Democrats are considering questioning the original whistleblower at a remote location, concealing the individual's voice and appearance. Republican Senator Lindsey Graham has called for whistleblowers in the Ukraine controversy to testify publicly.
Fox's Rachel Sutherland. Chinese state-run TVs canceled the broadcast of two NBA exhibition games being played in